out on the devil, or if we do good or something righteous, we can say, oh, God, help us do that. But in reality, we got to take responsibility for our own actions. Be like, hey, yeah, you know, I'm a good guy. I did something nice for somebody. Or, you know, I'm an asshole. I did something that I shouldn't have. I feel like a total prick. And here's my joke. This guy goes to a doctor, and he gets two doctors, a black doctor and a white doctor. Which one is the real doctor?
Go ahead.
The black doctor. The doctor with the little black bag.
What did you guys think of that joke? Give me a thumbs up if you like it. Give me a thumbs down if you think he should suffocate on his own butt fumes.
I gotta admit, it kind of went over my head, too.
Kind of weird. Okay, give us another joke.
Another joke?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Dance.
Dance? Yeah, but I ain't got a webcam. Give me a minute, and I can... All right. Give you something good. On jokes. Jokes. Sorry, Mr. Keene, I ain't got nothing. What you got?
All right, why does Mike Tyson cry after sex?
I don't know why.
Mace. It's an old one, but a goodie.
Let's
see what we got.
Here's a dirty joke. How do you make a hormone?
Let's hear it.
How do you make a hormone?
Let's hear it.
You pinch your titty. Give it a good old twist.
Oh, that's rough, man. It's hateful. Oof. What about you, Isis? You got a joke for us?
The only ones I know are really, really dirty.
Let's hear some dirty shit, then.
A real, real dirty joke.
Mm-hmm.
A long time ago, my brother told me this one joke. It was really disgusting. There were three dudes in heaven, an Italian guy, a Greek guy, and a Jew. The Greek guy liked butt sex, the Italian guy liked to eat pizza, and the Jew loved money. God said to both three of them, I'll send you back to Earth if you guys, you know, refrain from doing what you love the most on Earth. And they agreed, and they, you know, poof, they ended up on Times Square. They're walking around on Times Square in New York, and the Italian guy, all of a sudden, there's a pizza shop. He sees the pizza shop. He buys a slice of pizza. He eats it. Poof, he leaves Earth. He goes back to heaven. So it's just the Jew and the Greek guy. They're walking around or whatever. The Jew sees a $5 bill.
Little fucking root.
What?
The Jew sees a $5 bill, bends over, and then him and the Greek guy go back to Earth. They disappear.
That's hateful. Rob,
that was terrible.
What about you, agent of gout? What do you got for us?
Every time someone says dirty jokes, the first one that springs to mind for me is, why are all Jewish men circumcised?
That's rough. Let me see what we got.
That wasn't the punchline, Brett. That was actually the question of the joke. Why are all Jewish men circumcised, Brett?
Well, go ahead.
Okay, it's because Jewish women won't buy anything unless it's at least 10% off.
Oh, that is fucking hateful, man. Damn. It's pretty good, pretty good.
Brad, I got one, Keith.
How'd you add tofu and not her boyfriend? You're still trying to hit on tofu?
That's right.
Alright, here's a relationship joke. 0 to 2,000 in 6 seconds. Bob is in trouble. He forgot his wedding anniversary. His wife was really pissed. She told him, tomorrow morning I expect to find a gift in the driveway. That goes from 0 to 606 seconds. It better be there. The next morning, he got up early and left for work. When his wife woke up, she looked out the window and sure enough, there was a box, gift wrapped and all, in the middle of the driveway. Confused, the wife put on her robe and ran out to the driveway. Brought the box in the house, and she opened it and found a brand new bathroom scale. Bob has been missing since Friday.
Oh no!
Oh, man. It's the Pope! What's going on, Mr. Pope? We got a bunch of lousy-ass human beings in the blog TV right now on the list. You see them all?
In the blog TV, give me a moment.
Just randomly, here, I'll give you a link. Just randomly pick out assholes with the intellectual capacity of a fucking banana and give it to them.
You know what?
May I start with you? No.
Sure you can. Clap if ever you like. That's why it's called the hate book. Aaron to everybody.
I'm not even ready. I gotta get
started. I just brought in Big Mouth Big Lundy, if he has the balls to come. I got something to say to him.
I saw your video about Hate Club. I saw your video about Hate Club, and it seemed like you seemed kind of hurt. Like it may have been hurt feelings.
Well, it's a good fucking idea, man.
Hold on. Let me grab it.
Yeah. See you later, Panda. Be cool.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Brett Keen. Make sure that when you get an opportunity, you check out my main YouTube channel, Keen Vlogs. B-L-O-G-S.
That spells moon.
I know a lot of YouTubers out there, atheists and Christian alike, you enjoy drama, so I'm going to give you a surprise. Last night, I sat in a blog TV that was hosted by Agent of Death. But after I myself, as well as a couple other friends, stepped into the blog TV, we had went in the blog TV thinking...
We already know this video. Come on, man.
...about his content.
One moment. We're almost there. It's not a long video.
But what it turned out is the moment I stepped in, it turned into like 10 minutes, even 20 minutes of people talking shit in text, as well as in a Skype conversation with about the views about me. That's right. It turned into a blog TV about Let's Hate Brett Keen.
What, Brett? I don't think that was the case.
They fucking were mean to me, man.
Attacked the living shit out of me.
Come on, Brett. Come on, we weren't so mean.
We attacked the shit out of you, Brett.
What are you talking about? We weren't so bad, and you got to deal your fair share of hate and Hate Club.
Oh, no.
Why are you talking like we're so mean? It's Hate Club. Just had them trying to have a good time.
Well, if I get on video and I sit there and go, oh, yeah, it's fucking awesome, man, we just killed things. You're like, well, what's the fucking point of coming? Brett Keen's having fun. If he's having fun,
exactly. You know what? Who did I say that to last night? I swear to God. Exactly. All right. You know what? That's point from Brett right there. I like honestly.
Well, they want to see a crucifixion. They don't want to hear about some dude having fun at it. That's the point.
The audience. I'm off. I'm off. Yeah, all the time.
You gotta have killing.
So we hated on anyone yet?
Well, we had some dude telling a joke, and Isis, she told a joke about somebody getting done in the butt. And then there was, let's see what else we got. Some panda girl. I started to go off on her, but Happy said no. So we gotta pick out someone else. Hey, there's an idiot. Hey, Lolia Princess, how you doing?
Oh, shit.
I'm just kidding with you, guy. No, I'm not. Let's see what we got here.
I was telling that early apprentice exactly who I was talking to. I told you. Didn't I tell you last night, apprentice?
Huh?
You heard me. What do you mean? Fuck you. He was right about Sister Sunshine. We talked to her.
You did? Well, that's weird. I actually got a screenshot of me doing an email with her. But besides all that, What you guys up to? We can also invite him to the call as well. Be part of the hate club.
Just so you know, Brett.
Hate club.
Just so you know.
I know that name.
Oh, goodness gracious. How darn.
Didn't Sister Sunshine pull like a Brett King in reverse?
Yeah,
she
went to the atheist side of things.
Oh, she started a winning team.
Since the Sunshine Brett King are friends, I don't know what you guys are talking about.
I didn't say they weren't friends. I said she pulled a Brett King in reverse. Brett King went to the Christian side from the atheist. She went to the atheist side from the Christian.
Here, do me a favor real quick. Here, take a look at this. There we go.
And Brett, so wait, what's up with that video you sent me? Are you a Christian or not? Or are you just asking questions to atheists as an atheist?
Oh, the challenge thing where I ask people to be able to do 50 questions.
Yes.
Well, usually one thing that I've discovered between non-believers and religious folks is non-believers usually enjoy questions and challenges, and they like to answer stuff. Yes, religious people stuff, and it's like, oh, you can't question me and my view. I find it interesting. Don't
that's
you like
the true, right? Actually. I never thought of that before.
It's true.
Chicken kiss in my
ears. Yeah, Matt, where's the file?
Yeah.
You see it?
No, where's the file?
It's in the group call.
Yeah.
The sending failed. I don't think you and I are contacts.
Alright.
Oh, no.
Can I just read it out loud?
Sure. Can you also read the date on it as well?
Yes. All right. So it says it's a re-hey is the name of the message from Sister Sunshine TV to subscribe to Keen Blog. That's a terrible name, dude. Subscribe to Keen Blog. The date is August 2nd, 2012. And it says, what? I still am friends with you. Send me the link so I can see it and respond accordingly. Somebody must have started a rumor or something. I have no clue why someone would have the impression we are fighting.
It's the interwebs! Everybody.
Oh my god.
Gossip and rumors, some of bitches.
Are you in here, hello, little princess?
He's added to the call if he wants to join.
The screenshot is right there.
Yeah,
if anyone wants to grab.
You are in the call. I just heard you talk.
Yeah,
just
read
it out to Twitter. If anybody wants to see it, click on the TwitPic icon, and you can see it for yourself.
And even if it were the case in some kind of weird paradox dimensional world and stuff, why would you care? I mean, seriously, what's the fucking point?
Hey, what are you guys talking about? Catch me up.
It's like, haha, you don't get along with Boo Boo Doo Boo anymore.
No, I didn't say that.
He didn't say that you're fighting.
Being a douchebag.
He didn't say you're fighting now. Dumbass.
He acted like a butthurt little
bitch.
Keep your story straight. Where is it, the sunshine that won't talk to me? I can't have my speech up
That's funny because I don't recall making that video and shit.
Yeah,
because
you don't got no brain cells. Your memory's for shit, you douchebag.
Oh.
Yeah, I do have to admit, Brett, you kind of have a problem recalling the videos you've made.
Yeah. I've
over 1,000 videos. It's hard to remember shit, but I don't recall
this. I'll give you that when you make 1,000 videos.
Brett's getting old. He's getting old, son.
And Mario.
Keep the story straight.
Fucking retirement home.
That's right. I need to put me on a diaper and I'm a walker.
But like, yeah, anyone? What are we talking about Sister Sunshine for?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
A lowly apprentice has made the claim that Brett has been a douche to her.
But yeah, he was. Yeah, he was.
How did he douche her? Like,
oh,
you know,
this is
speaking
what
of manual douching, was it a perfume-based?
Sunshine got tired of being put in the stick end and just peppered with 50 zillion questions.
Is it being called a douche a compliment? I could
no,
be wrong.
Certainly not.
That's you.
For you, maybe?
Mm-hmm. Kind of floor. Like someone calling you vagina eater. You're like, oh, okay.
That's now, hard, but you eat, Steve.
All right. Do we have any other people who want to be added to Skype? It's exciting.
Dude, yeah, we can't have any more people.
The next round of ads.
Brett, how do you support yourself? I asked that question. What What's your primary source of income? Is it YouTube?
He sells heroin.
Well, really,
why do you want to know what I do to support myself?
I'm just curious. I would like to know you.
Look at the blog TV screen. Look. There's one. Where's the other one?
There we go.
There's the other one, too. That's how I support myself.
You get people who watch your ugly mug all day and they send you money how?
Send me money how?
PayPal.
I am not going to sit here and share my fucking personal things that I do with my wife with you goofers.
You've done it so many times before, I'm getting out of your
I talked about a couple things in the past of what I do for
just
myself.
Just a couple.
Right?
So
yeah,
Wix only has two things on it.
He like sells methadone.
What the hell's methadone?
You don't really need to sell methadone. You get that shit for free from the methadone clinic.
Warning, some of the people I just added are like a box of razors in a crowd in a mosh pit.
Damn, man, that's a lot of fucking people.
I mean, there's a box of razors.
Yeah, and one of those is Real Man 1 Trillion, and if he gets in here... If Real Man 1 Trillion gets in here and finds out the rules to the room, we're all in trouble.
We need to get Fleet of the Geek. She screams and yells and she's in a Skype
conversation.
Oh, yeah,
bring Fleet in.
She'd be like, fuck you, Brent, son of a bitch.
She has recently said that she's drunk drama for a while, but I will send her a personal invite.
I have a serious question. Who do you think is your number one supporter at this time? Who's your number one supporter?
Big Bravo.
Happy Kevy.
My number one supporter?
Yeah.
Happy's got it. The e-cooking goes to Happy. That's right.
It's Jockstrap is the only thing supporting them right now. That and government cheese.
Is Jockstrap?
Oh, government cheese. That's actually like the best kind of cheese. I used to get in line for Reagan cheese. Like 20 years ago, when I was a kid, we were in line for Reagan cheese. That 5-pound brick of cheese goes good with fucking broccoli.
Does
fucking making fun of poor people happy.
Probably.
Fucker.
Oh, wow, that's so amazing. Somebody left this call.
When they do that, poor, we're such wonderful, kind, merciful people.
Interesting.
Bullshit.
So what sort of revenue? You have one partner channel, or is it generating any revenue? I haven't looked to see how many subscribers you got.
Why is that so important to you for?
I'm interested. You know, actually, Abe lived out...
Because all you gotta do is go to his YouTube channel and see it there.
You guys suck at hating. What you were trying to do right to say right now is, Brett Keane, why the fuck are you on YouTube making all these goddamn videos when you have so few subscribers? That's how you hate. Alright, then you let him
do it.
Asking him these kind of beating around the bush questions, it doesn't lead to hating because he can just write. I don't think he knows how to write that off. Like, bam, bam, bam. Like, knock you guys out of the park.
My hand is not right. Superdyne. You gotta get Stiggy for the 100% hate stream. Where is he anyway? Where is that fucker?
Having Stigmadane in the call made it like a fucking Howard Stern episode. That shit was ridiculous. Like, I was like, he was retarded. Who is that guy?
I was hoping that Ryan would get in here, but he said something about, I'm watching fucking Marge Landy. I'm like, why? Come on.
You know, Phantom Pussy won't fucking unblock us. That's what the fuck it is.
Oh, that's sad.
I gotta ask.
I was wanting to hear him get up here and go, oh.
Oh, goodness.
Is the Mars landing another friggin' drone landing, or is it an actual people landing?
Yeah, they're sending a fucking toy with wheels.
Again?
Yeah. Apparently there's something there on Mars that we didn't see.
Sending people, man. They're just beating a beat. I'm shutting up. I'm stoked. What? I'm drunk tonight.
He's like, fuck it, I quit. Fuck it.
So, Mr. Pope, what do you think about the idea of once a week he just has like hate club thing going and people get to kill each other and tear each other apart and get out all that steam and anguish? What do you think?
I think about it, motherfucker. I made a video about it. I'm here for the second meeting. Obviously, I think it's awesome. You know what I think about it? I think that it needs to be hosted by me next week because
I'm
you guys get this hating going a little bit more lively. lot of hating going on. That's what I feel.
You need to get
Napalm. I don't know.
Someone get Napalm.
Napalm? Oh, hold on. If he's online, I'll get him. Hold on.
That dude can do some yelling and screaming and shit. Did someone just shit on Skype?
Like right into the microphone.
You shit your fucking pants?
Your fucking pants, man. Holy damn.
That's the kind of hate I'm talking about.
Oof, goodness gracious.
It came right from the Taliban.
Oof.
Brett's been talking all this time, and all of a sudden we have a problem with someone shitting down the microphone.
can't even talk without somebody doo-doo in there.
Oh, shit. That's eye callants right there.
I hope that you have to use that microphone consistently when you're making videos and remember what you've done.
Okay, hold on. M.
Wow.
M. Let's see.
Okay, who chased the puppy turtle off?
I don't know. I fucking added him so I could tell him, you know, if he had a problem with me saying that I was gonna fuck him in the bitch tits till I impaled him to death, he can fucking have it out right the fuck now.
You said you were gonna fuck someone in their tits?
It was hyperbole, goddammit. Hyperbole.
Agent of Gout just took it to a whole new level, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to have to work.
You don't fuck someone
there.
In their tits. You fuck someone in between their tits. That's what
he said, between the tits.
Oh, in between the tits. Okay.
No, he was
tits.
He was very clear. He impaled some tits.
If Napalm gets online, he's added to the fucking call. He's not online right now, but... You know, anyone who wants to fucking jump in.
We need to get K-Bitch in here. He'll be like, you motherfuckers, you. Mm-hmm. And get him in.
Yes, this is what I'm going to tell you.
Be like taking on a junkyard dog or something.
Old Vampire just said, I feel Skype raped. Just for being brought into a call with you, Brett Keane. She feels Skype raped.
Isn't that fucked up, though, Prophet Muhammad? He's right. 26 people are actually watching this shit as opposed to a Mars landing. They're like, fuck, planet exploration.
That shit's going on. I'm going to minicam that shit and broadcast it in the corner. It's not like your fucking whole face is even on the screen.
That's true. It's true. How the fuck would I go about doing that?
Your minicam?
Okay. Because
that's what we need to see, Brett Keane motorboating a fucking Mars landing.
Yeah, you should broadcast just the Mars landing and then just have us talking over it like idiots.
That's what
that sounds like.
Let me see. Let's see.
Someone get that out of here. That's what Bears, he could do it.
Okay, let me type that shit in.
Is that happy, Cabby?
Somebody is really hurting their asshole over there. That's fucking rough.
Exile?
Jeez Louise. Exiled, is that you over there? My goodness. I'm going to get you a clothespin for that thing.
Uh oh.
That's what we got.
Oh no.
I shit my pants.
Oh, is this the space land? Oh, yeah, no. Okay.
Hey, Isis. What's up?
Hi, I just shit my pants.
Gracious.
I'm sure we got a fetish for that in here somewhere.
Launch Mars rover landing coverage live. I think I might have found something here.
Let's see. There's a link in your window, Brett.
Oh, you got a link? The only thing I see is something about being Skype rate. That sucks.
It says NASA.
Okay.
Scroll down.
That'll be a clue.
Okay, there.
That'll be screwed. The one with NASA.
That one?
Is NASA still around? About NASA got shut down.
NASA's still around. Yeah, fucking stupid. Jesus Christ.
Who's
hitting the percolator? Let's see what we got.
I don't like the percolator.
Sources.
You're hitting a bomb. You think a percolator is? That's a fucking bomb.
Oh, when you say percolator, I'm thinking about, like, you know, you can get a bong with a percolator added.
James like needs one of those. James needs, like, a subcutaneous machine, you know, to fucking just push a button and shit. He's that far gone. He needs a mask like Bane, so he can just live that way all his fucking life.
I used to have a bong gas mask. I should have worn it.
See, I joke. Fucking fact is stranger than fiction. Shit.
I mean, how's that going? This is
turned the rate down to zero or whatever on many cams, so I didn't skip so much.
Can you guys see the shit?
Yeah, but just turn the rate down to zero on many cams.
My gosh, she looks like my grandmother.
I can't.
You can't turn it down?
Oh, turn down the volume.
Well, no. On minicam, not the volume. On minicam, there's a little bar.
Man, this fucking face attracts some heavy-duty trolls.
Okay.
You can scroll it to the left, and the video won't be so choppy.
Okay, you guys able to see that?
Trolls for the win! Troll here!
It's all good.
Welcome to the call, Lafayette, motherfucking.
Oh, yeah, no, Betty.
Why have you not cleaned up fucking Houston, Lafayette? That's what I want to fucking call you. All that fucking shit coming out of Houston.
Well, all I see is a bunch of fucking dudes in a room where the fuck's a little machine at on Mars.
It's on Mars.
That's
on Mars. You're not going to see a picture of the thing on Mars because it doesn't have a camera pointing at it.
Didn't they put a flip-it camera in at the end?
No, they forgot.
Fucking bastards.
Ow. Fuck.
Oh, God.
Lafayette, you need to turn your fucking mic up.
I can't see the fucking test screen now.
Lafayette, this is Hate Club. If you don't fucking turn your mic the fuck up, I will accuse you of having a cock in your mouth.
Turn it up, you fucking muttonhead.
There you go. You're brought in this call so you can yell at us.
I want Diana.
You fucking tell him.
Fucking tell them. We need to bring more people in the help. She was on the Christian chat room, Bert was trolling earlier. I saw her there. Steel Kugani. Oh, God.
Gotta give her Michael
Clifton.
Scale?
Scale Kugani?
Huh?
Oh, here's a good one in the blog chat. Does the NASA Curiosity Rover have a Made in the PRC trademark?
Is this an experiment to see if we can break Skype?
No, we've done that already.
I joined a call and there's like, and I can't even read the names and the text is so small from all the thumbnails.
Let's make sure that we're all coming over good on Blog TV at least, though. I can't see the fucking text screen, unfortunately. Can you hear everybody going to the Blog TV, ladies and gentlemen? Please give a thumbs up. Let me know what's going on here, folks.
I
can't
see.
As long as you can hear me, I'm good.
Who's Diana Boston? Right. Why is everyone talking about Diana Boston?
I don't know.
Apparently, she's quite fathomable. That's what I'm hearing.
What?
She's the hottest.
No, she is not.
She's
no.
A full-fledged Jew now.
She's a what?
She used to be pig, and now she's a Jew, but she hangs out in Christian chat rooms.
She does Torah studies now.
She was hanging out with Catholic nuns for about a month.
Does Torah studies with George Soros?
She's doing the same thing on her new Torah channel that she did right when she first started in here.
This is the person on YouTube? What the hell are we talking about?
Agent, whatever happened to Stigma? Did he make it to Texas, or is he still...
I fucking tried to add him to the call. He made it to Texas, apparently. He made it to Texas.
Are you fucking calling for me?
We need somebody who screams and yells and makes extremely incoherent arguments.
Dude, I'm afraid that if you get him to where you had him last time, you're going to paralyze his fucking vocal cords.
I don't see the problem.
Oh, because he decided to shack up with Sabella Summers. He's not afraid of knives, apparently.
They're getting married apparently this month.
Yeah.
If not already.
Who?
Sigma Dane has married Sabella Summers.
Now, someone told me
that they didn't get married yet.
Who's
not yet.
Sabella's ex-boyfriend.
Not yet. There's still time.
Lucky.
There's still time. He still has hope. Those two of them both have hope.
Wait a minute.
Who's just like, who's getting the hope in this situation?
Yeah, you gotta flip that around there.
Bunch of hopeless motherfuckers, honestly. Jesus.
I don't even know who Sabella is supposed to be marrying. Who's this person?
Sabella Summers. She's the one who had the incident with the knife. You will fucking listen to me, bitch. And she was stabbing a fucking, I don't know what, but it was fucking freaky, like fucking psycho freaky.
I'm still not sure who this is. I don't keep tabs on, well, not on every single crazy person.
This dude, you need to fix your mic. You sound like fucking Kenny off South Park. Fix that shit. So, are we going to be able to get Fleet of the Geek in here and stuff? I want to hear some screaming and yelling.
I added her, but...
No, please. I'll take Stigma Dane first.
Do me a favor. PM her real quick and tell her she looks like a fucking Chucky doll. See if that gets her.
I got in trouble for making fun of that shit during the HIV AIDS.
All right, I'll tell her for you, Brett.
Oh my God, that's what y'all talking about. I was trying to stay silent, but fucking, I got the motherfucking pussy going at me for making fun of her with Dre. I don't know if any of y'all remember that. We got Stan Devshell's blog to be for all the 15 fucking
seconds.
No.
We need to get you, James, in here.
I do not think I have him on Skype. Somebody else is going to have to add him.
I love how everyone, like, every once in a while, like, every person who's mentioned, one person's like, no, don't do that.
Oh, man, this shit ain't even in color. Look at that.
What'd you expect?
I expect some fucking color. Looks like they're just going down a gravel driveway.
The first pictures that they received were not going to be in color.
They should have took a high definition camera.
Fail. NASA, fail.
They should have used a bloggy.
Why is all this Valor not in here? Did you add him?
I can't add him. He has me blocked.
Put that beady-eyed toad on here. Let's see what he's got.
He's an interesting person to me, Aldous Valor. He's probably the only person in this little clique who I've watched the most of.
Yeah, me too. I'm a secret fan of
his. He's not on Skype a lot. I like both Agent and Aldous.
Aldous needs medication.
That's believable.
You know what his theme is? His green shoes, because he wants people to talk about him.
I don't know why, I just watch that guy
for
anything. I don't even know what he's saying. I just like watching him.
Yeah, seriously. Like, you know, like the crazy dude on the bus or something. Like.
Hey, wait a minute. You know, Felita. No, she got rid of me.
She's in here. She's just not on the call.
Hello? Is this thing working?
Oh, who's that?
It's Lef. I got another microphone.
Hey, we can hear you now.
Oh, wow, you sound a lot better.
Yeah, it does sound good now.
Because I was using the one on my laptop because I was too lazy to go get my headset.
Getting coffee.
I like to hear my surround sound, 5.1. Yes. Oh, man, they need to show some more of the shit. I'm just seeing a bunch of people next to computers. I feel like I'm at a YouTube convention.
I mean, better than staring at your fucking forehead. Honestly, when we go back to start.
They won't be able to show anything. The thing's moved out of range.
Oh.
Aw, Sabich unfriended me while I was...
So the rover's moved out of range? What happened?
The problem was that we get the signal from the rover because it transmits the stuff to the Odyssey, to the Opportunity satellite that's orbiting Mars, and the Opportunity satellite moved out of range from the rover, so it has to, you know, go around the planet once to get back into range.
How long is that going to take?
I think like... No, not a long time. I mean, the stuff goes around, satellites go around the Earth in 90 minutes, and it's a much bigger planet. So probably about 60 minutes.
This shit looks like a miniature version of Short Circuit, the movie. You seen that, Johnny Five?
But Mars is bigger.
That's a fucking thing.
Mars is like smaller.
Number five alive, Johnny.
Mars is smaller than the Earth?
Yes.
Yeah. It depends on where you put a satellite in orbit.
That's actually a little weird. I didn't know that, because Mars has, like, the biggest canyon and the biggest mountain in the universe.
Yeah, the Earth is the biggest one of the terrestrial planets. It's Earth, then Venus, then Mars, then Mercury. In that order, from biggest to smallest.
Yeah, happy you don't want to see the Mars ship? That's pretty cool.
Yeah, no, leave it on.
It's fucking epic, though. We're sitting here hating while
watching. I'd rather look at that than Brett's face.
Yeah, seriously, Brett. You didn't even have the cameras angled correct. Just leave it on.
One, two, three. Anybody hear me?
I can hear you.
Thank God. I thought my mic's being a fucking douchebag again.
Well, it is basically on some kind of fucking, like, endorsement of, what is it, propulsion laboratory, okay. There's nothing going on the screen right now. I'll go ahead and put my ass back up through the scroll a little bit. That way people realize they're talking to a human, somewhat. Let's see what we got.
What? Did you just add variable ass to this fucking car?
Yeah,
right. Oh, no.
Yeah, well, he's the N-word guy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Let me turn up the brightness of this shit. Can you guys see me out there and hear still? Or no, y'all? Wrong
people? I don't know. Where's your sunglasses?
Get ready, people. Brent?
You have a blast on Skype.
Brent?
I used to, but he got a new Skype account, apparently, because I didn't have that one.
Was he on the call?
I don't think he's on right now.
He's not online.
Napalm online? I'm trying to...
He's in the call. All he has to do is get on, and he can get in.
Hey, Brad, I got a few questions to ask you. This is going back to when you first came on to YouTube. Around 2006, during the time of Hellion Exciters, Cyclone Hurricane, Renetto. Were you on around that time as well, 2006, 2007?
Renetto was around. The Casey guy, he was around and shit.
Pipstrello!
I think that they were on their way out. I was around when Captain Awesome was pretty big at the time. He was actually liked before his little incident.
So,
let's see. Any more questions?
What do you think of the YT Watchdog?
YT Watchdog. Not exactly sure. You'd have to familiarize me. Is that one of the names for one of their other channels?
The guy who always wears that friggin' dog mask on his head has a really high squeaky voice and turns up the pitch of all his videos.
Stigmadane?
That sounds like Stigmadane to me.
Yeah.
Except Stig doesn't really have a squeaky voice. He sounds kind of like, he kind of sounds like the Get Dunked the Goof guy. Actually, not how to think about
it. You just have to piss off Stigmadane as much as Brett Keane does. And then you'll see...
Yeah, and it goes, with a shit ton of R's.
Yeah.
Well, give me a link to this person. Let me take a look at who you're talking about. Let's see if I can remember.
Because I haven't seen him in a while, and YouTube's getting kind of boring to me. Let's see what y'all... They call him out of retirement. This fucking dog fuck is, you know, it's funny as hell to watch.
What the hell is this shit? This is the dude you were talking about, the squeaky voice?
Yes, sir.
Let's see what we got here. Okay, it sucked. I'm done. That's my feelings, aren't it?
Yes. I agree with Brent.
So you think... So what's your opinion on the YT Watchdog?
And the person I just watched?
They're fucking awful.
They suck. That's fucking dull. It's boring. I'd rather hang myself in a fucking coat closet than watch more. How's that sound? Let's see what else we got here. We got someone else posting a link. Let's see what we got. See. Oh, yeah, that's Casey. Yeah, this is the guy that points guns at the fucking screen and says, I'm going to shoot you through my fucking broadband internet. Yeah, I remember this guy. He's
a lot of people have done that shit.
Is he your
I think Neth has done that. I think a lot of people have done that kind of shit.
I only expect that kind of behavior in a Christian, you know, though.
I think it's kind of, I think it's dumb to just expect one side to be crazy. I think there's crazies on both sides.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah. The rumor that's going on right now, the Hellions in jail, what are the supposed charges?
Shit.
Yeah, sorry.
Who's Hellion?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Thank
God. All right.
Can you guys all do
it? Hate, man. These guys are talking about the stupidest shit in the world. Who the fuck is Hallion? Who cares about YG Watchdog? Jesus Mary, motherfucking Joseph. They've been monopolizing the conversation with toxic dips and shit.
Halcyon is in jail, that creep motherfucker with his eyes who was sunken into his head.
What do you mean he's in jail, Ellen?
That's what someone said, and someone. That dude scared me.
He was selling coke. Hold on, really? No, seriously, what happened to Halcyon?
He's on Skype right now. So I don't think he's fucking.
Everyone, calm the fuck down, and we can, you know, maybe get some answers.
He's a hypno, too.
You know what? Fuck it.
I just asked him if he's in jail.
You're not naked, are you?
Pull him into the fucking call. We'll ask him to his fucking face.
Wouldn't it be a bad thing if Halcyon got arrested? Would anybody really care?
Which Halcyon are we talking about? Are we talking about Halcyon, TJ's Bird Boy, or are we talking about Ebola?
Yeah.
Yes, guy.
Probably that one.
Bird Boy, yeah.
I'm talking about the guy whose eyes are too sunken.
Is that Gallant's in here? Is that Gallant's in here?
That's me. Oh, shit.
Okay. You have a different name. I just wanted to make sure you were in here.
What's up, Exxon?
Hey, you.
Hey.
Hey, don't be hitting on Exile right in front of Lily Apprentice.
We hate each other. Don't worry about it.
There's hate.
There's hate.
And disgust. There you go.
Okay, well, no hate fucking either.
I have one person who doesn't love me.
Odd Syndrome says, can you fight? Why are you wanting to fight?
The only reason I really dislike Exile is because she's friends with the AOD, and I just can't stand it. That's
which
one?
The
Agent of Gas, Alliance of Demons. I can't. Zerota.
Oh my god, man. Don't do that. Don't do that, Icolette. Don't talk about a group called the Alliance of Demons seriously. Don't even acknowledge that shit. Like, it's not
you're
real. It's not real.
Like, your kids is like my son.
I can hear you.
Alliance of like one or two people.
Well, we can't fucking call them just that group of people on YouTube.
No, yeah, you know what you do? You don't fucking talk.
Stick that bright teeth going is going right on his YouTube channel, right?
I'm getting a call from a different
phone right on.
Yeah, just hang up.
That's all about. Let me see if I can add this critter to the code.
Yeah, let's see if we can add these people to this.
Oh, what the fuck?
Like double call. How the fuck
what the fuck have I gotten brought
it's
into?
Just
like,
it's in better gorilla, I think.
Yeah, isn't that
add IG to the call.
Is it old Adventure Gorilla?
It's IG.
Ooh, no kidding.
Hey Christian, you didn't get to hear it, but before you came into the call when you got added, it went off like a fucking bad fart in the room. Like a fart in an elevator, dude.
They call themselves demons. That shit's hilarious. I love that shit.
Alliance of Demons.
Somebody, Chrome, wants to know how much you can bench, baby.
How much can I bench?
I can bench 160.
Brett can bench a fucking cheeseburger, motherfucker.
I'm the king of all burgers.
I can leg press over 700.
That's cute, too.
Brett's wife scares the fucking shit out of me.
I can squat 275.
Like Dick, sir, get the fuck out.
This doesn't relate to Brett, but when I go to the gym, I can leg press 980.
That's not anything.
Have you seen IG's physique? That man's a fucking god. Seriously.
Press
780 pounds on my legs.
damn.
That's weak as shit, dude.
That's hateful.
Pretty good. I mean, you know, it's, you know, leg press is one of those workouts where you can do incredible amounts of weight. So.
Yeah.
I mean, that's cute if you're like fucking 14.
Yeah, right. You're 980 pounds.
I mean, how much do you weigh? Shit. How much do you weigh lifting 980 pounds? And how tall are you?
I wrestle you.
I used to be honest.
I'm a big boy.
You can wrestle sometime if you want.
I know, I have to ask this question. How big are you, Chris Fitzwinners?
I can outdrink everyone.
I'm done after like 2 beers. There's actually about to be a video on YouTube soon. But anyone here know who Jamoki is? Jamoki Music?
Didn't you promote someone named that?
Well, he's way bigger than I am. He's like 20,000 subscribers. But I went out with him the other night and we got drunk.
Oh, you went on a date with him?
Kind of. No, I'm joking.
I'm actually pretty jealous.
I got so plastered. Oh my god, I'm such a lightweight. I embarrass myself so much, and there should be a video. So for me, I cannot remember doing this, but it has been recorded, plastered as fuck, doing karaoke.
Oh my god. That's always a good time. Yeah.
Well, karaoke.
To answer to your question about how much do I weigh, I'm 276 pounds at approximately 5'9". Sorry,
that's all you can press.
That is
a picture. Yeah,
no, 6'4", 250 pounds of pure sexual erotic power at home.
I'm 6'6".
What can you leg press, Christian Winters? What can you leg press?
980.
Dawn's probably. I think Dawn is better at that.
I'm
5'4" and I can do all that.
Dawn has got your ass whipped.
All right, let's have a leg pressing competition.
All right, here we go. Okay, I did it. I'm done.
I can't. I can't.
Oh my god, everyone, are you guys looking at the blog TV screen?
Oh god.
Brett's bare naked ass legs.
Go to the gym, right?
Brett, lower
the camera so we can see your ass. Do it like those little blog TV girls do it. Come on.
Show my ass. Like, I want to see some booty. Show up the atheist ass. I hear it's got a halo on it.
I like how we're all getting along and this is called hate club. I mean, what
the fuck? Oh, I get all of you. I'll say it from
destruction and bloodshed.
I'm having a good time.
Hey, there's a link.
Hey, right, you look like you're constipated.
I am. I'm going to be shitting out a suitcase soon. How'd you know?
Hey, Christian, did you produce any music today?
Did I?
Yeah.
I guess you could call it that.
He made love to a cheese grinder. It was the best sound of stuff he's
Where's the fucking music from your fucking supposed band that you fucking supposedly have?
Fuck you.
He's like,
you know what? He can suck my cock, dude.
Here's my impression of Sarah Hunt.
No, you're Firefly. Remember Firefly?
Firefly, let's see what we got.
Firefly.
Hello, everybody. This is Firefly today. Let's talk about having sex with trees. There we go.
I knew it.
He made a big flex. I'm not making fun of it, dude. He actually made a big flex.
He made all his videos laying on his bed.
He was talking about how beautiful it is when trees make love to trees.
I want to see the fucking video Rip's talking about.
I don't know if it's still up, but it was awesome.
A video about making love to trees.
It was about trees that mud for trees. I don't know if exactly participating.
They got those nice big holes in them. Oh, yeah. Especially with those branches that look just like a dick. Oh,
yeah. This is a sick thing to say, but I can see Stigma Dane actually making love to a tree. I can't.
Stigma Dane has a fleshlight.
California and on Mars. I
want to
present to you the team that has
brought us
next to
Oh, that's
me.
Hold on.
Sorry.
And I just love sticking my dick in trees.
King of burgers.
Oh, hey, noob.
Go ahead, Luke.
All right, see you there.
There's a victim sexualis people that have sex with amusement rides and the Eiffel Tower and bows, archery bows and shit like that.
Where do you find a good cock size hole in the Eiffel Tower?
I don't know. Listen, they were all chicks, so it don't matter.
Oh, that's probably the least.
It's on YouTube. Yeah, just look that up. It's really
you
weird.
You just sort of rub your crotch up against something.
No, that's
exactly.
That's not funny. Video online of a girl having sex with the corner of her sink.
Why did you
the best chick was the chick in love with the banister in the church.
Hey, we like Aquafina Bassett was hiding out under this chick's house, sticking a dick in this chick's hole under the floor.
Uh oh.
And this chick mistook it for a fucking hot dog.
Oh my goodness.
Squatted right down on it, had fun. But when another person came knocking on her door, she kicked it right underneath the refrigerator. So that poor bastard.
Okay, well, now I'm horrified beyond belief.
It's about 2 inches
shorter.
I thought you said the dog ate it or something.
Hey, Christian.
I'm afraid for my penis now, sir.
Christian.
I want to think about your penis.
I'm clear, good buddy.
Christian, I was trying to find music from your band, so I went to Stroke Botics, and all I found was, like, shemale porn.
Oh my god.
Where's your Stroke Buttocks band? I can't find the link to it.
You gotta look for it, bud. You gotta look for it. It's up there.
It's between the cheeks.
Nope. Deep. Between the cheeks.
I'm going balls deep.
Oh shit.
Oh yeah.
I don't know. Who do we
have? Brett makes love to the fucking mic. What the fuck? I can hear everything that goes on.
Bro, yeah. I can hear stuff.
Oh, my God. Oh, no.
Brett, you ever rubbed one out live before? Just, like, not told the audience?
No.
That'd be awesome.
What the fuck you think he's doing right now on Blog TV?
Or had your wife? Hey, or had your wife do something? Oh,
that'd
be
with where his head is right now, he could be motorboating anything.
I'd like to see Dr. Fetch press Brett right there on the bed.
Oh my god, that'd be awesome. Come on, Brett.
Hitting themselves on Mike.
No, do that thing where you balance him on your feet.
Let's see some gymnastics.
Spit for a little circle.
Let's get extracurricular.
Somebody said something about a reverse cowgirl. What's that all about?
All right. I have a message to someone in the audience. Her name is Nerdy Dancing. Add me on Skype. I'm easy to find, Agent of Doubt. And I will pull you into this Skype call. And you can scream at whoever you want in the call. It is Hate Club.
She's in the call.
She's in the call?
Better be interesting.
Waiting for
Felita
to come in here.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I just added
you, Mr. Mitchell. I want
the
audience to know one thing. I hate you all. I fucking hate you all.
Didn't Felita close her account to leave?
No.
No, now she's on her channel singing sad love songs. Every Felita has its thorn.
That's just an old-fashioned love song.
Hey, you guys fucking make fun of Felita.
Goodness, man, did you squeeze your balls when you did that?
You guys make fun of fucking Felita, but you know what? She said she was going to make some music, and you can fucking find it on the internet. What about fucking Inventor Gorilla? You can't find any of that shit.
I listen to Felita the Geek's music. I got to be honest with you. I've heard cats fucking more harmony than that.
Whenever Felita sings, I always imagine a bunch of cats dying.
You're playing live. Go there.
What? When was that? That was back before your hairline receded, motherfucker.
What's he talking about?
You should just let your hair grow out gray. Stop worrying about coloring it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I look like Kenny Rogers, then. Nobody take me serious.
Hi, I'm Kenny Rogers.
No,
nobody take you seriously now, Brett.
No. I definitely don't
take you seriously now.
Seriousness that people take with you. That would definitely be a helper to the seriousness factor. Straight up.
Oh, yeah.
Just an old-fashioned love song playing on the radio.
Is that our Christian
version? I like that song. I grew up with it.
Oh.
Must be on the
time. It's an oldie.
Well, my friend's over, so whenever I sign in, my
friend's over. Oh, Brett and his wife is kissing.
God, I just threw up.
You just noticed that? We must have major lag. That
That's
was 10 minutes ago.
That's the best thing that got into your mouth.
Ooh!
Wait,
that was hardcore. That was
something you just threw up in your mouth. That's the best thing you've had in your mouth.
Oh.
Hey. Oh, Mrs. Key.
Hello.
Who's that? Is that Botster?
Who's Botster?
I heard, oh, is that Mrs. King? It sounded like Botster a little bit.
Botster or Botster?
I don't know how to. I usually just say Volkswagen. I can't ever get the name right.
That's fucking hilarious.
Get my name right, asshole.
Everybody, Nerdy Dancing is now in the call, and everybody, please go easy on her. She just got through with some slow motion epileptic seizures.
How slow? Keep that
worthy. Nerdy Dancing.
Yeah, you want to talk that worthy? There it is, right
there. Uh huh.
Hershey on her old channel, Mrs. Pure Fiction, right? That's what
we're Yeah, but now she does belly dancing.
She's awesome.
Ooh, belly dancing.
She's confused.
Slow motion seizure would have made
for
her. Turn the light off, Arnold, quickly.
I smell some wiki wiki coming on.
Mm-hmm.
Divert your eyes, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to get X-rated.
Oh, shit.
Oh, God, it's raid time for me.
Raid time?
Yeah, raid time.
Wait, Exile plays WoW.
Yes. Go ahead, have at her.
Oh, that Exile?
I didn't even know.
No. What Exile servers do you play on?
Mongolian Tundra.
No. Like U.S. servers, European servers?
U.S.
Damn it.
Yeah.
James, you
play
WoW?
Oh, I'm not playing WoW.
Oh. Exile, what are you doing?
Actually, kind of surprised. I thought Exile was like too mature and adult or something like that.
God, no. I'm so immature.
You bought from the delicate.
You motherfuckers just pay $15 a month for that shit.
Oh, please, go play. Fuck off and go play Minecraft and shit.
Yeah, free. I don't know. Just
$15 a month? What?
You know you spend more than that on corn.
Hey, Brett,
I was like $200 a year.
I thought you said corn, that's why I
laughed.
Hey, Brett Keen.
Yo, yippee gay. What's up?
Wow.
That's a favor for anybody else who does vlogging and. Excuse me.
What the hell was that?
I got a message. Actually, need some help. This is my channel right here. I posted it in the Skype chat. And I need some subscribers if you want to put
stuff
up.
Okay.
Well,
that's a good idea.
Let Brett.
I go to the channel and immediately. I see a 4-minute video with a thumbnail of your cat. Not helping this pause.
Yeah, I know.
What can you do to get me to want to subscribe to this channel? Fill my feet up.
You know how you
don't.
If you want James to subscribe to your channel, just offer free weed and bongs. He'll join your channel.
I've subscribed actually to many channels because of that. I have not gotten one free bong.
Actually, I just help getting some subscribers in my subscriber base, people who actually watch the videos. I don't care if they troll me or not. It's just
What the hell?
I'm having a hard time getting it going.
Would be Christians in this call?
There we go. It's good.
Yes, we have a Christian in this call.
It's Christian Warrior. We have Christian Adventure Gorilla.
That's Christian Winters, not Christian Warrior.
Oh.
Yeah, but both of our Christians are appropriately labeled.
I didn't know. I thought his name was Christian.
It is.
On my screen, Christian, the other guy just says Christian, and then I see Christian I on the other one side.
Yeah, that's me. Inventor Gorilla.
Yeah, no, I know it's Christian. I thought your name was Christian Inventor Gorilla.
It is.
From channel, yeah. Isn't it Inventor Gorilla?
Yeah.
Check it out. BK with Mohawk.
So what? Are you Christian and also named Christian?
Yes,
no,
he is.
I don't have a religion. My name's just Christian.
Inventor Gorilla is that way. He just dropped a call. His internet is sucking, but... Yes, he is a Christian named Christian. And you are a Pope that is not Catholic.
Who's better than one?
Is that James Pope there? Is that who that is?
That is the James Pope.
Wait, Mike, are you looking for a Pope that's not Catholic?
He's in the call.
I thought James Pope.
Oh, goodness.
So somebody has a lot of cereal in the house.
There we go. That's a cool effect right there, ain't it, baby down?
I got a question to ask for the audience. Is anybody familiar with the BattleTech or MechTech or MechWarrior universe? Because that's what my videos and my YouTube channel is pretty much about.
Dude,
look at that, giant ears.
I know exactly how you get more subs. Just start making videos about something else.
Something that doesn't involve, like, hey guys, talk about MechWarrior
Warhammer. Yeah, ears.
Bad idea.
Hey, dude, I got do not bring up the word of Blake.
Hey!
Giant ears, see?
The word of Blake. I can bring it up at all. I'm very, I know a lot about the lore.
I'm sorry, but like MechWarrior, and that is somewhat of a turn off to just watch some dude sit there and talk about Warhammer and shit.
What's the problem with Warhammer?
Are you a Christian too?
Hey,
are you like the Christian in the call? Token Christian.
Anybody who plays? Don't be a freaking stickler. Get into it.
Come on, you hateful bitch. Bring it.
Get involved! Paint an action figure.
Participate.
Actually, MechWarrior is based on a 7.
Like, why aren't you doing something with your life, man? Get involved. I've got laughs.
Come on, you fucking mutton head. Give it to us.
I mean, I'm like, Brett's changing voices, and I don't know what the fuck he's...
Wait a second, Mr. I. Callens, I call you out for pussydom because you've now been in a call with an AOD member for at least 5 fucking minutes, and before that member came in here, you said you fucking hated AOD.
I dislike Exile because of her relationship with Zeroda, and...
Oh, now it's just Zeroda?
Saying anything.
Come on, you boring fucker.
She's not saying anything, though, so I don't really know what to say.
Oh, now her internet's fucking dropping out.
I wanted Snow for so long.
This pure fiction hasn't been, like, in the AOD. I don't
know, I don't
think.
Sorry, folks.
So I can't really attack myself. Well, you know.
No, don't.
And Exile isn't really in the AOD. She's just friends with them. Although James is like, stop calling them the AOD! But, that group of people on the internet, there you go.
Nah. Oh, barf,
I think I know 4 people in the AOD.
Now you're all yellow.
Good kids.
So, isn't it a big group anyway? There's like a lot of members, right? Or at least a few.
I don't know.
I think if you asked a couple people, they would probably say I'm a member of the AOD.
I mean, when I first started YouTube, actually, if I'm just going to be real about it for a minute, those motherfuckers were, like, huge behind me when I used to debate Crazy316. I'm not even sure if he's still on the channel anymore.
Oh, I remember him. He was
actually hot. I love
Andre. He was one of my favorite people to interact with on YouTube.
That's because you like fucking with him. You trolled the shit out of that dude all the fucking time. I remember your videos to him. And like when he tried to talk to you, you like, it was funny, but you were condescending as fuck to that dude.
Oh god, it was easy as hell. It was easy
to shine.
And he was pretty fucking stupid too, so it was kind of like picking on a really
stupid guy. Man, to eat you, dude.
What?
Someone was coming to eat him. I look at his screen. I see this big old set of teeth. It's like, what the fuck? Someone's gonna eat him. Goddamn.
You do what with the mop?
Christian is like in some sort of parallel dimension or something. I don't know what the fuck going on.
What's this? Here we go.
I'm crazy, you bastard. Fuck. Get off my back.
Mine is gone. Right,
this is gone from like a hate party to like sexual escapades between old people and like. Deluded crazy dude. I guess
this is not a hate club meeting. This is just, I've taken an excuse to be rude to everyone because we said it is the meeting.
Where was you born, Brett?
Where was I born?
He was born in a hospital.
In the Twilight
Dome. Oh, God.
I was born from somebody's vagina. Let's see what we got. Why are so many personal questions? What do you want to know all these things for? Let's see.
Liar, Brett. You're
Is it enough to know that I'm an asshole?
You over there.
Brett, you're a motherfucking liar. You were not born of a vagina. A bird shit on a rock and a fucking sun hatched you.
Somebody's asshole.
So is this like the replacement for Steve McFan or something?
I'm like in the game.
Now that we have like a much larger audience, is there anyone here who has that video of Brett? Coming out and saying that he's not fucking atheist anymore.
No, it does not exist, you freak.
It does so exist. I watched that. Sorry, but that's not true. I watched it. I remember watching it.
The thing is, it's across like this. This is the thing. It was probably either deleted by, well, it was deleted by Brett.
No. Nope.
And you'll probably have to look for it. That's
it wasn't because it was never put up. It was never posted. It was never
outside of the video. I remember.
What the fuck ever? You can
find it and prove it.
Checking my videos, I'm looking for comments, I'm looking for trolling, I'm looking for everything. Come on, people.
What the hell?
What the fuck
is who probably would have it, who I probably would not be able to get it from though, is Riff. Riff probably has it.
Yeah.
But he's not gonna talk to
me. No. Scott probably has it though, right? Was Scott around during that time? Because he probably has it. Skeptical Eric probably has it. He keeps a lot of old shit like that.
What should you looking for?
The video
where he comes out and says that he's basically not atheist anymore.
If something did exist like that, why would they care? Just curious.
I was arguing with you about it the other night, and you were just like, "No, that's just because you're not, because you're saying that it doesn't exist, and I know it exists." You're like, motherfucker. If I saw a rabbit hop by, and this rabbit was like, fucking talk to me or something like that, and fucking I saw this rabbit that talked, and everyone's like, "No, you didn't. You didn't see this rabbit that talked. You're crazy." I would be fucking crazy until I found out that this talking rabbit existed. And you're trying to say the talking rabbit doesn't exist.
True story.
He's smart because he knows that unless you can actually produce it, he will just deny it. That's the problem, though, is actually finding what you need because he'll just say, "Oh, I don't know what you're talking about."
It's sitting there somewhere.
That would be a very big fucking bet.
Probably no. Michael could probably find me.
Thing is,
I actually cannot.
Good point, though, Brett. I wouldn't care. I wouldn't even give a shit about the video at all if you were like, yeah, that happened. Like, it wouldn't be a big deal, but you make it into this big deal by denying it, which probably works.
I agree with James. I don't really give a fuck who Brett scams, to be completely honest with you. I dislike Brett for my own fucking reasons. I don't really fucking care who you fucking scam, honestly. I mean, fuck.
I don't fucking care who all y'all are.
Seriously, I don't really fucking care who you fucking stand. I mean, for shit. Most people are fucking assholes.
Seriously, though, in Brett's defense, I've seen 3 videos produced by James of people who say they saw it, but I know what mass hysteria looks like, okay? I've been in a church where fucking the whole fucking church is rolling and feeling the spirit of God, and they're all fucking, they got the hysteria together.
That's a terrible fucking argument, though, because it's not like, you know, this is Jesus or something.
Not one of those fucking videos pointed to a video in the fucking description.
No. I've actually been a victim of mass hysteria. I can actually hear what you're saying to a degree, but Agent, and anyone else in this call, am I the only person who's saying they saw this video? Because I'll take into account that maybe I'm mistaken, but I really seriously feel like I saw this video. And am I the only person saying that?
I do remember a video.
He was outside.
Jesus loves lives.
He was outside.
Even
if
he turns on his feet.
And he loves feet. Lick the feet. Lick him.
That was 10 minutes ago, man. Mr. Nash, you need to get in the flying DeLorean and go back in time.
back in time.
I hear ya.
Okay, Stigmatane version 2 is a bit too loopy for me. I mean, what the fuck? I mean,
where
is Stigmatane? This guy ate him, apparently, and took his place.
Oh, it's peanut butter jelly time! Peanut butter jelly time!
Okay, Michael.
What's up?
You gotta fucking stop this shit, because this is irritating. This motherfucker is irritating.
Which motherfucker?
Oh, my ass.
Lick your ass. There's nothing.
So we got any videos? I mean, I keep hearing all this cool stuff, but you got something for me?
I can honestly say I never saw the
Mr.
Brett Keene.
Mr. Keene, I heard that one time you were a Muslim. Is it true?
Yeah. Actually, I saw that in a Coughlin video. You're actually worse than Islam.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
James, you can probably find it, but, you know, there are a lot of little troll accounts that save his videos anyway. It's just the thing is, you gotta know which people to ask, because they do save his videos.
It would be very satisfying to pull that video up, but I can't say I really get that much of shit to go investigate it.
It'd be satisfactory.
I don't particularly care, so, I mean, like I said, I don't really care who Brett scams.
I mean?
Yes. Well, I mean, you know, scams, that's a whole, oh, Jesus, I don't know, that's a whole other thing. We're going to start calling everything into question.
Yeah,
there's my butt.
I mean, I think you had the most moderate feelings about the whole issue with the e-begging shit, if I remember correctly.
Hold on a second. Happy, are you still there? Happy, you still there?
Happy's not in the call.
Happy's not been here for a while. I mean, e-begging, but I don't think e-begging's the same thing as what Brett was accused of.
Hello, everybody, this is the
Happy Brett was accused of.
Look at the screen, quick. Hello, everybody, this is the Happy Gabby.
I thought you liked Gabby, Brett.
Did you ask if he was here just to make sure he wasn't so you can make fun of him?
I've done this for him before, he thinks it's fine. Here we go. We got a Mars landing, right?
Brett, you are such a gigantic dick, bro.
Who, me?
You are. You talk absolute shit about people who are cool, who you're supposedly cool with, like, all the fucking time. Right. I personally don't care. I think you're fucking hilarious when you do that shit, so
There is someone in the room right now named Start Making Sense, and I would like Start Making Sense to add me on Skype, Agent of Doubt. I will pull you into this fucking call, and we will fucking grill you, motherfucker.
I don't think
anybody
really gives a shit about the issue he has with a lot of people. I mean, to me, it's just a racist scumbag on the YouTube.
Which racist stuff?
The biological reality of race.
We got all these people.
Anti-racist equals anti-white.
Man, I'm not racist. I hate everybody equals. Fuck y'all.
Anti-racist equals anti-white. Yep, it's one of those people again.
I'm me, man. I hate everybody equally. Fuck y'all.
Fuck y'all. Fuck you right in the goat ass.
What the fuck?
Let's see what
that's I'm damn doing. Right. Hell with you. Mm. Fucking horse you rode in.
That's right. You tell them. Tell those mofos. There
we go. Ain't nothing first.
Crazy.
So Agent, Agent Michael, we gotta plan these better.
Yeah.
In the future, we gotta plan these a little bit more before we have them.
Because it's like, people just wanna jump in the call just to jump in the call. It's not even, there's not even a point to it anymore. It's just like,
we should instigate shit and then try to get these two, like, the instigated parties.
Dude, we've got Start Making Sense in the crowd right now. We could so fucking hate on him.
Dude, no one fucking cares though. I mean,
yeah, like, what are you talking about? Who could we hate on? Who?
Racetard in the fucking blog
but
TV.
No one fucking cares except for, like, maybe you.
Yeah, just me.
Wait. Oh my cabbie. God, I see a cat. Oh, there it's gone.
It's fucking Cabby is here.
If the skeptical cabbie. Heretic would get the fuck on the online.
Oh, shit, it's Cabby.
Hello. What up, Kenny?
Oh, that's Happy Cabby.
Damn, James, please lay on the sexy voice.
Shit. Yeah, we gotta work on the K Club. Should I expect him to kind of be like, motherfucker, oh, fuck pants.
I mean, it was fucking hilarious the other night, but now we have a bunch of random fuckers jumping in the call talking about all this
shit. And shut your mouth.
You shut your mouth. Whatever.
Shut your mouth, huh?
You tell him. That fucking mutton head.
Like I said, we need to plan these things. Well, like James said, we need to plan this shit out better. Because this sucks.
We will.
Oh, man. Fucked up
again. I'll get to Skype and y'all and it'll happen.
Somebody in the call has Inventor Gorilla blocked. And it won't let him back in the call.
My God, it's a fucking clown! Ah!
You blocked. Aim.
Well, if you're wondering why we don't have a token Christian, it's because one of you motherfuckers blocked the token Christian, and now we don't have anyone to fucking hate on.
No, it should only block if the host has you blocked.
I don't have anyone blocked.
I'll get him in.
Excellent. Chris Gorilla's back.
What's up, Mr. Inventor?
What's up?
I don't know what that
is. Talking all kinds of shit about you. What do you think about that?
I think that makes me sexy.
You can see Brett's leg in the mirror behind him.
This is
holy shit, Brett. Are you fucking serious?
That's hot.
Yeah. Here, see?
It's getting weirder and weirder. I get pulled over for no fucking reason, not speeding. Fucking cop asks me, is there marijuana in my vehicle? No, I let him look through my vehicle. He finds a gun. I ask him, why did he pull me over? Well, he says he likes me, creeps me in, says, can I please go now? I go to work, bust my ass off, the friggin' machine breaks down, and it's fucking nuts.
Okay, this is...
What the fuck? What was that all about?
What's what?
What Christian was saying.
He said that... The cop that he was on the road or something, and the cops pulled him over and like made sexual innuendos towards him.
They raped him.
And then he went to work and some machine broke.
Sir Jim, and he liked it. Somebody used their nightstick on him, and he was like, "Oh yeah." He was like, "Full handcuffs will make it." I reckon I like French fries and potatoes.
What the hell is OZ Syndrome talking about?
Let's see what we got. Oh, someone decided to manufacture a Brett King Kristen video real quick. Just so they can feel that satisfaction. Now that's fucking brilliant. Even purple.
Can someone...
Miss Fiction, I love you.
Damn.
Anyway, somebody link me
this
a
link. This is something that has been very
good. Yeah, you guys are just going to listen for a second.
My mind for a while now. Oh, Gene, here we go. I told a friend of mine named Jake.
Oh, Gene, out of context.
I've also told a friend of mine.
Oh my god, it's 14 minutes long. I can't.
I've already done videos talking about how I used to be a Christian for 15 years before doing the atheist thing. That's what you were wanting to know.
Alright, but that's not the point of the video. The point is that...
all that shit.
I mean, it's bullshit. Dude, Brett, we all know that you pretended you were fucking Christian or agnostic or what the fuck ever you want to call yourself just not too long ago to scam some money from fucking Christians.
Yeah, nobody, it's just like, why are you denying this?
I mean, dude, no one fucking cares. Nobody does. But you can perpetuate this
nobody
bullshit.
Nobody cares that you did it. They just care that you deny it.
Exactly. Nobody fucking cares. I don't care. Nobody fucking cares.
Well, if you don't fucking care, people, why do you keep asking me?
Keep lying about it.
He comes with implement on, doesn't he?
He sounds like a permit to fuck us.
Exactly.
Kermit Frog recently became an atheist because it's the only rational way.
Wait, Christian, did you just pussy out and say no ad homs? This is fucking hate club. This is all about ad homs, motherfucker.
You have to be hateful.
That's the whole
point. What the hell are you fucking accusing me of saying? I didn't say shit, goddammit.
You have to be hateful, you walking vagina.
Wrong Christian, fucking Christian.
This is cheap tobacco.
It's a pipe tobacco.
If you want to see someone do differently, then jump into the Skype conversation.
That's what I
stand
for, is people calling Brett saying he does
tobacco. If you say that, they'll go at it really hardcore.
Is that bath salts, Mr. Smith?
No, please, please, Brett, don't say you're smoking bath salts.
Cheap tobacco.
Are you smoking bath salts?
No, we don't use bath salts.
Oh, thank you.
I don't know, it's something in the news that's turning into a drug or something, I don't know.
That's the guy who ate that other guy or something.
Well, Felita just said she'd rather be injected with HIV than be invited to a call with all you vile cunts.
Because she is weak.
She is weak. Honestly, though, I'd have to side with Brett on that one. It does display a certain degree of weakness.
Okay, that right there was a little worth it. I fucking hate that bitch.
Fragile.
I mean, it's fucking fragile. Hilarious that... Wait, I find it fucking hilarious that a bitch like Felita would not want to join a call with us when she does shit like this all the fucking time. I guess it's okay for her to not join a call with horrible people.
Well, I understand.
I
completely understand because we bend her over our knees and spank her properly.
Right. I guess it's okay for her not to join, but whatever. It's fucking bullshit. It irritates me.
Tell her she's weak. She sucks. Not in a good way. Let's see what we got.
And it kind of actually proves a point when people say that she is a two-faced bitch who talks shit about people behind their backs, but whatever.
I was pulling people in here so that they could say shit like that to their face. And, you know, it's the awesome opportunity to scream at each other face-to-face, but, you know, whatever. People don't want it.
Yeah, it's true, though.
Blatantly left as soon as she was noticed. It was like she was chatting in the type for like a long-ass period of time. And then as soon as somebody mentioned her name, it was like, oh, all right, finally, I got noticed. And then she left.
Of course.
Well, she can...
She was typing something, and then she erased it, and then left.
The best thing is that...
The child is enough to
thoroughly
enjoy that.
She actually vindicates all the shit that people say about her, too. So,
by the way, there, Brett Keane.
Yep.
Felita says you look like Chucky Doll's mom.
Chucky Doll's mom.
so she
doesn't even have a mom.
Chucky, no, he's a fucking doll.
Factory.
Alright, we got Start Making Sense. He's coming into the call. He's added.
Tell Felita that if she wants to fight, stick her head up her ass and fight for air. That's what I think. Goodness. If she stick her head up her cunt, she'll lose it. Don't do that.
People are like, there's one stick her head up there.
Well, bile.
Okay, from the nasty smell. Nasty stank. Stank.
You tell him.
Well,
it's sad. We can actually get Stigma Dane in, and he will yell and rip off heads and shit like that, but she won't get in. That's fucking...
No, because she's a fucking coward, like you said, and I agree.
That's the one thing about Stiggy. He's not a coward. He's an asshole, but he's not a coward.
I fucking respect that.
Well, I gotta say, as far as Felita, I had a feeling she wouldn't want to be here because she's on this kick of not wanting drama. And maybe it'll be different in another week.
She's been having some depression issues and some issues, and she's trying to stay away from drama. And, you know, she's trying to stay away from drama. We gotta respect that. Call her a cunt behind her back.
You mean like, well, she'll call us cunts behind our back, surely.
Well, she's gonna do that anyway. But, you know,
You don't have to put effort into staying away from drama.
We got anybody out there on Fox TV who wants to join the conversion?
The people who fight are addicted to it like heroin.
As she goes out, Nurse Dancing pretty much called it. As she goes in the room as a guest,
Headless, you wanna tell me something?
Yeah, don't invite Felita into calls like this ever again, or you're gonna get blocked.
Yeah, you're the third motherfucker that's told me that. She's gone around and told everyone that, and she also sent it to me directly.
She
sent it to me directly.
I can't hear half the stuff moving.
Yeah, and Noob has also typed it to me, but Noob's in the call. He could have said the same thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
There'd be like 50 people talking at once.
Like, what does Felita told everybody mean? Like, all four of her friends?
Like, she
talk about
I'm getting PMs from other people. Like, it's so fucking evil to bring her in here where she can fucking just talk it out. You know, we've been doing this for fucking, what, a total of, like, 8 hours now, and it hasn't fucking hurt anyone.
You're telling me you guys been doing this for fucking 8 hours and you haven't gone to see the
total, motherfucker, total. This is like hour two of this one.
We got on the list in the blog TV room, a fucking pass at this. Ugh. Gross. Get your ass up here.
Where is it?
Get out there.
Somebody send me a link to the blog.
Get your ass up here, you fucking...
Okay, there, Start Making Sense.
On Skype, get your ass up here and show us how pacifist. Really.
Thank you, James.
Put it in the chat, Tony.
Thank you very much, James.
So, Start Making Sense. You're in the call right now. Can you say something so we can hear you?
Yeah, I'm here.
You're here? Okay.
Yeah.
So, my beef with you is second party.
Alright, what's that? Sorry.
My beef with you is just that you did something to my friends. It's not first-hand fucking beef here. And I'm waiting for the Skeptical Heretic or Hannibal Barca to get on the fucking Skype so that I can bring them in. But I will say to you, I fucking hate the way that you're willing to fucking censor people, motherfucker.
Right, so who have I censored? Actually, before you go, though, I'm going to tell you, I'm in a really bad mood. I'm really sad right now.
He's really sad, guys.
This is probably
the
wrong place. I don't fucking care about your issues right now. Give me 2 hours and maybe I will.
Let him finish.
But if you guys want to try to attack me based on shit that you don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
Now I know who you are.
If the dude's serious, though, relax. What's going on with you, man? What's up?
Brett, you know who this is.
Brett, this is a call. No. Fuck that. Do not care what's going on with
this. So eight people are going to talk at the same time. That's what this is.
Yeah.
Well, this is
this is the fight room right
here. Yeah, it's a hate club, man. Don't you know that?
Okay, so Mike,
it started making sense before you got here. We were actually making fun of Brett Keane like 15 minutes.
Yeah, now it's your turn.
No, so I'm telling you guys, Brett, you know who I am.
And it's his call, and it's his blog TV, and we're making fun of him.
Yeah, Brett, you know who I am.
Who is it?
Y'all get you hurt, bitch.
Let him finish!
I'm gonna leave if you guys are just gonna all.
Oh, it's Adam. I know who you are. Yeah, go ahead, man. Let's not be mean to him. He's cool. What's up, Adam?
If you guys want to have a discussion where you actually do a back and forth, that's cool. If everyone's gonna
Adam, I don't want to be rude. I want to show you a video just so you can get an idea of what's going on here right now. Because I feel like people come to this and they don't get the context, and they feel like we're just being a dick to them personally. Check out that video. You don't even have to watch the whole thing. Just watch the first minute and you'll understand what we're doing
here. Yeah, this is
okay. I'm watching the video.
Yeah.
I'm being a dick. I don't really care. I mean, this is personal.
You can't be what you already are, honey.
I'm glad you can see the true me.
And everyone in the blog TV should watch this video, too.
I'm glad you can
see. Throw it in the blog TV so everyone fucking knows.
Is Do the Devil's Work, Mr. James Pope?
That's me.
Okay, hold on a second. There we go.
Oh, I love your video, James. I've seen that shit like 3 times now.
So this is just like a hate fest, all right.
Yes.
Yeah, where people abuse the shit out of each other. Yeah.
Alright, so I just... Okay. So what's your beef? What do you actually have that you hate me for?
Personally, I am an advocate for freedom of speech. And when I get my fucking hands on whatever anyone wants to fucking take down off the fucking internet... I'm going to put it up. I'm going to fucking have my commentary all the fucking over it. It's going to be fucking fair use. Anyone who's fucking censoring anything off the fucking internet, I'm going to fucking do that too. And it'll be fucking legal and no one will be able to do shit to me. Motherfuckers.
So what does that have to do with anything I've ever said? Or
I've heard that you've been trying to take some stuff down off the fucking internet.
You heard. Yes. What did I do? Tell me a specific thing. Don't tell me I heard or I watched a video.
Well, I told you.
What did I do?
Oh, shit. You said fuck you.
He's starting to get into the spirit of it.
Yes. Yes, he is.
What did I actually fucking do to you that you hate me?
I've heard that you've been threatening legal fucking threats.
Not what did you hear? What did I do?
Uh-oh. I didn't hear. I didn't see it. Yeah, I heard.
You heard through the grapevine?
Yes, I heard. I heard from Hannibal Barker. I heard from Hannibal Barker. You're fucking threatening him.
Not what you heard. I'm gonna moderate.
Who specifically did you hear this from?
Hannibal Barker.
Fuck Hannibal Barker. You believe he?
Yes, I believed him.
Barker. Okay, what did you believe that Hannibal Barker said?
You've been making legal threats against him for putting up fucking works of yours that were uploaded onto fucking YouTube.
That revealed my personal information, motherfucker. The skeptical heretic fucking spied on me and took a fucking Skype call that had my fucking personal information.
We need to pause that. We need to pause that right there. How did he spy on you? What does that mean?
Oh, now he's
balling. He was like James Bond.
Let him go.
There are recordings that are being sent around, right? That have my personal information in them. Oh. Now, I uploaded part of this recording, but I didn't upload the part that has my personal information. So when this motherfucker uploaded the whole thing, the raw footage that has my personal information, I flagged that down because he fucking posted a video that has my personal
We need a hate club vote. There's nothing more to be said. Hate club vote. Is it okay to flag someone who has your personal information in the video? Go.
How did he get the whole thing, though?
If it actually had his personal information, his docs, in the call, he had perfect right to bring down the hammer of Thor. Like, it has been set by Brett Keane himself.
Okay, sure. I agree with that. But how did he get the rest? How did he get your information? You're leaving a lot of things out, which makes it hard to kind of.
I'm not leaving anything out. I just haven't had a fucking chance to talk because you guys are
okay.
Over me. You have had a chance.
Fucking guys. Never shut up.
Guys. Shut up.
The fucker is to give the guy a chance to talk. God damn.
Let the motherfucker talk.
Is this the talk over, everyone?
I have a question, Adam.
Okay, headless chicken.
This call that you had, where your personal information is revealed, how many people were in the call with you?
It was me and two other people.
And how do you know where it came from if you took the information out, put it up?
I know who recorded it, and I know who sent it to who.
Okay, and how do you know that?
Because I was in a conversation with them.
So they They're told you that they
so
told
because,
you that they did
it. Let me pause it. Because you heard. Because you heard.
Okay. You had your chance. You had your time to play. So the person told you they did this?
Listen, we know who did it. Like, anyone involved in this, we know who sent what. We know... Who was involved? One of the people. I'm not gonna bring this up because I don't feel like bringing hate on others. But we know who did that.
Okay, I have a question then. What my one question is, with your personal information bleeped out, would that video have been okay? Was there anything else that you didn't want heard?
Can I answer?
Sure.
Hey, listen, Hannibal, the fat-ass fucking Barca, made like a 30-part video series at me, okay? If you go to his channel right now, you will look and see, if you type in Start Making Sense, 38 videos will come up, okay? Did I flag any of those videos? Any of the other videos? Did I flag the part of the recording that didn't have my personal information in it? No, I didn't. I flagged one video that has my personal information in it because it has my personal information.
Did you flag it for...
I don't know, y'all. It's starting to sound like this guy's making a lot of sense to me. It's making a lot of sense to me.
Did you flag it for personal information?
Another question.
I have a question.
I just asked him a question. Did you flag it under personal information?
Can I answer the question?
Ask the fucking questions
already. Ask the fucking
questions. I'm trying not to
interrupt.
Uh-huh.
When you were recording the call, did you know that somebody else was making the recording as well?
Okay, when did I say that I recorded a phone call, Headless Chicken? Did I ever say
I
recorded a phone call? Did I ever say that? Did I ever say that, Chicken?
Oh, no, it was just a misunderstanding.
Don't fucking jump to conclusions. Ask me a question. Did I record a call?
I think he just misunderstood.
Guys, can I say something real quick? I'd like to say something real quick. This person who is called Start that is in the call with us, I can vouch that he is one of the most evil son of bitches of all. Do you know that he drew a picture of me with a dick growing out of my fucking head? It's true. Oh, it's true.
He's a dickhead.
He made a dick growing out of my fucking forehead. He is a...
That's a really deep metaphor. If you really think
about it. It is.
It's
very...
Spiritual
statement. The point I'm getting at is, if you know you're being recorded, why would you...
I didn't know I was being recorded, you stupid motherfucker.
Okay. Wait,
hold on for one second. It was kind of confusing when you said that you were in a conversation with two other people, and that your stuff was being recorded. That's why people think that...
Let me ask
actually, sorry, happy lawyer.
Okay. My question is, was this done over Skype?
Yes.
Okay. Then, by the terms of service that you agreed to, you have no expectation of privacy because people can record conversations. You agreed to that when you signed up for Skype.
I did not know that. Thank you, Happy Cappy, for the fun fact of the day. I gotta start putting my penis...
Look at how quiet everybody got while he was talking.
Because Happy's a fucking god.
He is a god.
Once you get into a group call with more than just yourself and one other person, you have no longer any privacy. Because
but you're not allowed to
know
that.
Yeah, it's against the YouTube terms of service, though, to upload it to YouTube.
Oh, goodness, you got it right.
Hold on for one second. Doesn't it also say that you can't download other people's videos and upload them to your account? At least that's what I heard.
This Skype call sounds like it's too much love.
I agree with you.
I got one more point of contention for start making sense. I got one more thing.
We'll just call it something.
You care, obviously, or you wouldn't have said anything.
There's no killing.
Right.
No destruction. Why aren't people going Old Testament up in that ass?
I'm trying. I'm fucking trying. I really am. Start making sense. Start making sense. How exactly did you flag it? Did you flag it for privacy?
It's not flagging. I mean, when you go to flag something for privacy, it goes to a separate thing. So it's
Okay, and that makes a difference, because when you do that, people get a chance to take it down before they get a strike against their account, and that does make a difference.
I'm still confused about
that. And I told him that I didn't want that particular recording up. He has 30 other videos attacking me, calling me a fucking retard, saying he's going to rape me in the ass and all these things. I didn't flag any of that stupid shit.
He said he was going to make love to your bottom?
He threatened to rip my ass apart.
Ooh, that horrible motherfucker.
Yeah, but we all know that was just a metaphor.
It was a metaphor for me.
Phantom, you going to come up here? It's fucking wonderful and loving and all that good shit.
Phantom Lion is in here?
Yes.
Yeah, right there.
Okay, can someone invite him to the call and kick start making sense out?
No, start. If you give start a little bit of time, he's kind of a build-up hater. You gotta give him time.
Work okay.
Yeah, no, he was doing some good hating there.
He will do some
good. He has ramp up then. All right.
Give him some time.
All right,
he's some of the best hating tonight, to be honest.
He warms up on his killing. He likes to eat breakfast first, then he does his killing.
Okay, see, yeah. I can get that, because he has like a ramp up time. All right.
So like I said, you don't really have anything against me. You just have this public perception of what stupid fucking idiots have said about me that's all bullshit. And you bought
it. But you also said that I heard, too.
So you're stupid. You're a stupid fucking idiot for buying into it.
Okay.
You didn't watch the videos in response. You just fucking believed what you heard and didn't look into it. How fucking stupid is that? You hate me. I hate you.
Motherfucker, I've not said anything.
I'm not talking to you, Oni.
That was a ramp up.
He was talking to me. I'm going to take what you said. I'm going to tell people that told me this shit to jump to an hour and 30 into this fucking recording off of Blog TV. And then I'm going to ask them to fucking back their own shit up, all right?
Well, you can watch the videos back and forth and see the info on it. I mean, we've been doing videos back and forth. I've exposed his bullshit.
He's
an exposure. What's your channel, man? Put that shit on YouTube.
It's Start Making Sense 111.
Oh, God. Can you just put the link in the chat? I'm not much of a tech.
I know, he's got the sentence structure of a fucking banana. It's ridiculous.
The banana that I made in atheist.
Are you guys done with the whole exposing spies? Where is he? Why isn't he in the fucking school?
She talked about the dirty nana.
Banana inventor gets excited.
That's right.
Okay, I got a question about dirty manners. What did Amazing Atheist do with that banana after he was finished with it?
He pulled the Chris Angel. That motherfucker disappeared. Never came back.
Amazing Atheist. That kid is a fucking idiot.
He did it because Felita asked him to, actually.
No, I think it's a
I heard he sent the banana
in front of the camera and upload it to YouTube. Yeah, fine. That'll make
I thought it wasn't uploaded to YouTube. I thought it was.
And
start making sense.
He
wants to leave, by the way.
What is with all the text messages?
Brett, your friend wants to leave, by the way.
Who wants to leave?
Start.
I have no further.
I'll answer them, but other than that, I'm gonna take off.
I have no further questions without investigating.
And it was nice at the end.
Have a good night.
Thanks for joining.
Let us know.
Yeah, wait. All
right, just
fucking Clark Kent glasses you wear all the goddamn time in your videos.
That was what? Who is keeps checking themselves like that?
It's fucking Christian, bro.
That motherfucker
makes... No, it's someone's chair every time they turn.
Bro, bullshit. That was shit. Chair noise. Chair. Awful bigot.
So it's Phantom back then.
Yes, yeah. Phantom is back.
Yeah, here. Excellent. Let's all doll pile on this one.
Look at this fucking idiot in Vlog TV. He says, Brad, how come your shit smells like flowers? I don't know when you come over here and check, you fucking bitch.
I know you
fucking
bitch. You see this guy's a weirdo.
Okay, we're not. Okay, for the record, we're not friends. We all hate each other.
I fucking hate y'all with a burning passion. So leave me the fuck alone.
IG has fucking pancakes and a breakfast muffin.
You just granted someone operator privileges and thinks my farts smell like flowers? Weirdo.
Are you knocking farts?
That's fucking.
Now, Oni, who are you on the list?
I can't lunch, bro.
Okay, hold on a second. There we go.
Alright, but IG has fucking a breakfast buffet at a church. Okay. I want to go to that fucking church, man.
You can make everybody.
Right, yeah, that sounds awesome.
Why not? I can make everybody good damn.
Cut it out.
Fuck it. Let's make them off the line. Who gives a shit? Freedom of speech, right?
Freedom of speech, not freedom to kick and whatnot.
I'm not going to kick anybody. I'm not going to kick anybody.
But he's making everybody in the list an operator.
Is headless chicken worth the shit?
Yeah.
Says headless chicken.
Okay, we'll add that something too.
Well,
she's Miss Fiction. Does she suck?
Yes. No, I don't know.
I don't know either.
Miss Fiction's awesome.
Is Salinas cool? Removed me as a contact because of the meanness.
Because he's blinded by the fucking AOD of Egypt.
Okay, there we go.
He's blinded by his allegiance to the AOD. Go fucking
this shit, is the Alliance of Demons like still around?
I'm not in the Alliance of Demons anymore. Mm. Everybody knows I'm not the AOD. So if you're just an AOD,
it's in the long left.
Whoever that is talking, you need to fix your mic. You sound like a dildo let loose in a metal room.
Look, Brett. Kill him tonight, buddy.
Oh my god.
That's Gary kept the fucking hyperlink in it.
Let's see what we got. I need a whoopee.
If you give me a cup, I'll go fill her up.
We will. That's sweet of you. I love you, boo boo. Alright, back to the killing.
Hey, this is Kate.
My name is J.D. McIntyre.
What's going on there, Mr. Inventor?
Your wife had a cute young sister?
She's got a sister, but I think her sister is hooked up with somebody.
Oh,
well. Yeah.
Eat that bitch.
When's that ever stopped you, Christian?
It never stopped me, but it's just good. It's good intel, you know?
Suggested this new version forever.
Oh, goodness. I got kids, man.
Do you? Shit, yeah. That one doesn't work at all. Fuck.
That's what adoption is for, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what adoption's for.
Yeah, oh, yeah, I should have went with adoption. Damn it, I missed that window.
See, that's why you need more Oni in your fucking life, nigga.
I, Callens, I have a question. I never knew you were black. This is news to me.
Oh shit, it's Phantom Lion! Holy fuck!
Hey Phantom, how's your pink eye?
I love that you know just from his
I wouldn't have known. Usually I'm used to you coming in and going, oh, curse.
I have. Oh! 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 No, I never knew Ike Callens was... I just never knew. I never knew.
I was actually kind of surprised when I found out too.
Oh my god, Phantom, you're white!
By your ignorance of my race.
Sorry.
Well, no, I mean, I knew a long time ago.
Kill them all. Kill them all.
Oh, not too Phantom, I'm talking about James, who just disappoints me.
They must be punished, Oni. Get them. Get them. There goes someone shitting their breath.
So bizarre. Hey, Phantom.
I am not real news.
I got your, sorry I haven't returned your PM yet, man.
Who said that? Oh, no, that's cool, man. It's, don't worry. It's alright.
How have you been, dude?
No, why do you think so high?
What? It's right.
Gee, you're so quiet today. What the fuck? Well, right now you're quiet.
We're drinking a bunch of beers, man. I was at a buddy's house watching the Mars shit. And then I came home and watched a little bit more. Now I'm here and I'm still drinking.
We were broadcasting it for a while there while talking and everything. It's kind of fucking boring though. A bunch of people just sitting in the computer room.
Well, you had to know when to watch. Like, it was real exciting from like 10:15 to like 10:35. Like all the exciting shit.
I got here too late. Fuck, man.
It landed and it went perfect, so. The thing
with the communication base on Earth, right?
Is there someone who's hostile and hates? Is there someone we can invite to sort of spice shit up?
Hostile and hateful. Fuck you, man.
We're all just tired. It's the end of the
You're not hostile enough, though, you pussy.
Yeah, I mean, work, you're like. And you don't have any, like. You know, history with anybody here. We need somebody who's just full of hate.
I would like to say something about the Mars landing.
Yeah, I'm just being respectful because Happy Gadsby's here and Brett, and I've seen a couple of his videos. He's a pretty cool guy. He's got some good points in some of them.
You're saying nice stuff again, though. That's
yeah, what
awesome.
The fuck?
Cabby! You're so
yeah,
white! Why is Cabby so white?
Alright, how about this, Keen? I fucking hate you and I want to gut you and hang you up by your balls.
Now that's pretty bad. Let's keep going.
You should just say something about the Mars landing. Don't announce it.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. What about the fucking Mars landing? Let's hear it. Come on, spit it out.
Fuck yeah, science. My faith in humanity has been restored just a little bit. Fuck yeah.
That's so fucking pathetic.
Millions of dollars to put a remote control car on another planet.
Yeah.
I hope they crashed on Mars. Yep, there goes $1 million, all right.
No, yeah. It was like 2.something million.
Billion.
We got a user in a room called My Lovely Dane. You want to come up on the Skype call, or is she already in under a different name?
I got her on Skype. I'll bring her in.
Fuck yeah.
Is she here? Somebody's farting and belching and getting all fucking weird over there. Stop with that. Nancy, you hear the wife over there? She's wanting to hear some hate. Let's see what we got.
Don's like the only person here who seems to respect the fucking purpose of this room. I'm fucking ashamed of all of you.
I've tried, man.
The only one who gives a fuck. I hate all of you right now.
And I'm the nicest one of the group, so get the fuck to fighting.
Seriously? I mean, for shit. And then Michael is like the fucking shitty moderator. He's just kind of like.
You go over there fapping.
I mean, seriously.
I have been fapping since Nerdy Dancing got in the call, I gotta tell you.
Videos fapping to her dancing and everybody else is just kind of talking and having a nice time.
It is my greatest fucking sexual fantasy to see somebody have a slow motion fucking epileptic seizure.
That's weird.
Fucking belly dancing people that show off their fucking toned fucking bellies. Bring in My Lovely Dame 21. She might have something to say about that shit too.
Get your ass up here and talk to us.
I'm definitely fat in this fiction video.
Yeah, but.
Well, people post up some videos and say, calling all assholes, you are summoned to the destruction table.
I did?
Have fun!
I had people fucking add me on Skype today saying, oh, please add me to the call when it happens. And then they're
girl
not
put up a 10 second
not online.
Say, come on, you pussies, here's the link.
Yeah. Michael, is Skep on? Is, like, Rith on?
Rith is on, and he fucking... Did he even stay in the call? I added him to the call. He's on Do Not Disturb, though.
Can you add him again? Tell him James is on here. There you go.
If it makes any difference, I hate at least one person in this call.
Congratulations. Let's hear who it is.
Yeah,
who is it? No, don't be too hateful to admit.
No, well, I don't actually hate Brakeen. I hate Agent of Doubt, and here's why.
Here we go.
He is. Well, that's even worse.
He wasn't feeling O-Dub, so now I hate the guy.
Go ahead.
Wait. Hold on a second here, Phantom. You hate Agent of Doubt.
What? I don't hate you. Not anymore, dude.
Oh, you don't hate me anymore.
Get no. to it. Oh, my God. Why
do you
hate
me?
Okay, wait. Shut up. So he can say we hate
you. So I'm no longer blocked on your Skype? Apparent reason?
No, dude, I'm sorry. It's just
already. Tell Munster. You hate him. Let's get the story.
I'll answer you later, Headless. Just, I hate...
Don't hate to put Headless in.
I hate Agent of Doubt because he just has no regard for you see this is why you never shake Agent of Doubt's hand because he don't respect Nada Holmes. Just has no respect at all.
Where's the link to the Phantom Lion
He has no respect for anything at all.
He has no love.
That's Michael.
Hey, no doubt, is this true? Are you a complete better asshole?
You know, if it were true, he didn't say it emphatically enough. I mean, I didn't feel the hate. I really didn't.
He expected
he didn't really hate you.
And you didn't drive it. What's the problem here?
I just think that you're a despicable son of a bitch, dude. I'm sorry.
I'm feeling it.
You ain't gotta be passive. You feel like you're so loved. You bitch. No, come on.
Yeah, I'm
like a petter ass or something.
It's,
if you're a fucking lion, fucking roar, motherfucker.
Fucking knees.
Well, it's almost 3:30 in the morning here, and I live with other people. You see, this is the difference primarily between me and Agent Adab is that I have respect. He does not.
Phantom, it's also 3 hours time difference from where Michael is, so therefore it would only be 12 o'clock where he lives.
Okay, that's him. That's not me.
We're too late for Earth.
We have like the Phantom Lion, Michael, and okay. She has no respect.
I'm going to return Volley, because he only gave me a 1-star hate rant there. I'm only going to give him a 2-star hate rant back. I'm going to say I fucking hate you, Phantom Lion, because your whole life has been a fucking lie. Everything you've said about your fucking life to me has been a fucking lie. You never had a fucking Sifu. You fucking stole the fucking life story of fucking Kung Fu Panda. And you never fucking lived off a fucking cactus in fucking Africa. You fucking liar that makes up fucking fantasies about your own fucking life.
Okay, wait, let's try, guys.
cactus in Africa?
You even look like Kung Fu Panda. You even fucking stole the Kung Fu Panda's look.
It was imported.
Man, but you're not just going to sit there and let him punk you out like that, are you? That stuff's been me here.
Damn, that was not a 2-star hate rant. That was definitely a 5-star hate rant.
Don't just sit there.
Come on, Panda. We got to hear some feedback.
There's like 11 people talking in my ear, so...
Yeah, sorry.
All right.
We'll let you talk.
There's 11 people talking in my ear, too.
Come on.
It happens. We'll let you talk, so... Fire back. Everyone quiet. Fire.
All right, cool. Well, dude, the whole cactus in Africa thing, that was obviously false, but,
Come on, man. You make me want to make love to a catcher's mat.
No. I've actually been very comfortable
lately. Since I've kind of distanced myself from communicating with people lately, I've found that my life is very peaceful. And
well, that's nice. Why don't you address what he said?
That's my point, is that I don't care about, you know, trying to appease other people, and I don't care about trying to explain myself.
Still not addressing what he said.
That's the thing. I don't care about, you know, making my life, I guess, accurate for other people.
Okay, so you're saying it's okay to lie to people. That's
oh, jeez.
Phantom, you drunk dial Agent of Doubt.
This is what
Nick yeah.
Yeah, what's up with drunk dialing me, Phantom Lion?
Oh, that's just me. I dial everybody.
And just to note,
I don't tell you
never gave Phantom Lion the phone number. Phantom Lion had to go to somebody else to get it.
No,
you went out with somebody on YouTube.
Actually, I called him to troll him. I did.
I drunk dialed you because I wasn't feeling well, and I thought you were my friend, and I thought you would help me out, but, you know, just...
That's a fun thing you did, Agent of Doubt. What's up with that?
No.
Okay. You know what? I learned my lesson. You know, I learned that I couldn't have Agent of Doubt as a friend, so, you know, my mistake.
So what's up with that, Agent? Why such a fucking prick?
No.
Why are you a prick, Agent?
You know what? It is very hard to be a fucking friend with me when I don't know thing fucking one about your fucking life. It's also fucking hard...
Why do you need to know about my life? Why?
Well, because I don't fucking know you, and all I do fucking know about you is fucking lies, bitch.
Well, you do know that he wears his mask in the bathtub. When you wash it, when he does this.
My life is not important. Just get this through your head. Everyone just what? Get this through your head. My life is not important.
Well,
what did she say?
My life is not important.
She said you wear pantyhose or something like that. In my head. Yeah, but what's wrong with that?
So,
go ahead, Phantom.
My life is not important.
Well,
why? Because I could die tomorrow, and within a time period of maybe 6 or 3 months, a lot of you will move on and forget about me. I'm not going to be remembered, I'm not going to be cared about, and eventually the years will go by and everyone else who knew me will also die, and then time will eventually defeat me. I won't even be in memory anymore.
Okay.
My life is not important.
Happy Cabby says, why is Dawn not in the kitchen? Is she on a break?
All right, bump, set, spike, here we go. Motherfucker, if your fucking excuse for lying to people is my life isn't important, don't be motherfucking surprised when you're fucking let down when you don't have fucking friends because they don't fucking know you.
I haven't lied.
Oh, really? Cactuses in Africa kept you the fuck alive? Where's your fucking seafood buried? Give me the fucking fucking epitaph, motherfucker. Picks or it didn't happen. You don't have a fucking seafood. You stole the fucking Kung Fu Panda's look and you're fucking parading it around on YouTube and you tried to get some fucking emotional fucking manipulation on people by telling them that you were in a fucking car crash, then you appear on Blog TV, there ain't a fucking bruise on your fucking naked body, motherfucker. And then you get on a fucking Blog TV, and you fucking got Zelda next to you, and she's fucking chatting to people, hey, tell them to stop touching me, and you don't know how to fucking keep your fucking paws to yourself, motherfucker. Answer for all that shit. I've never seen your true colors. All I see is Kung Fu fucking Panda.
You know what I see happening here with the way things are going? We're going to have one day for hate and another day for, like, love and sniffing flowers and shit, because I'm not feeling the hate right now, folks.
No, actually.
Okay,
that's some good hate. Hey, are you recording, Michael?
Oh, the whole time. The whole time.
Michael, are you recording?
The whole time.
Of course he is. Always talk to Agent of Doubt as if you are recording, or as if you're being recorded.
Yeah, but I'm just asking seriously though.
Yes, you're recording. Yeah.
So is it?
I am.
I don't know. Yes. I don't care though. I want an answer from Michael, please.
I am the whole time.
Thank you. So I gotta go. I'm gonna upload that shit though, because I feel like we got some good clips. Sometime
you taking off, Ernest Pope?
I'm taking off.
All right.
I'll catch all of y'all later.
Not going to be a video about Hate Club this time. This was all mushy, romantic shit.
No. I think I can edit some highlights. Make sure you go and like and subscribe to Hate Club.
Well, Michael, I hope you die gracefully. I really hope you don't die a horrible death.
Okay.
So, just because you hate me so much and spread all these fucking lies and shit about me,
you should just keep recording this. Keep recording this. This is good stuff. I gotta get all y'all a good night.
I hope you guys
see you later.
And peacefully, like you're going to sleep. But yeah.
That's a nice way to die.
Phantom, what lies has he said and spread around the internet about you, bro?
Yeah.
Have you not been listening?
Reiterate.
Yeah.
Reiterate. Make it clear.
You haven't been listening to this guy, and I have to repeat him.
No. You can say it, and I know, and other people may know, but for the group, you need to reiterate for the group, you know, and give context. To, you know, substantiate you saying, you know, that he's done these things. Because, yeah, I mean, I've seen things where I might consider, but, you know, that's just my perspective. So you need to explain to everybody here what exactly you're talking about.
You just heard all of the bullshit that he...
I know what Phantom's talking about. Phantom's pissed off about what Michael said.
I'm not even pissed off that, you know, that my tone, you guys commented on my tone. That's because
you were angry about it then?
I just don't care. You know what? This call, this blog TV is just a giant excuse for drama. You guys love drama because none of you have fucking lives. You know what? Tomorrow, I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna go to the city, and I'm gonna get laid. Fuck you people. Not all of you, just the majority of people.
Wait
a second, Phantom. How much do you...
I just got a rage quit point. Bum, 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 ba dum.
Phantom, why did you sleep before?
Didn't tell us what his rates are.
Don't you just realize he just got a goddamn point for rage quit?
Actually, I have something
when they go to town. They won't know how much money to bring with them to keep Phantom Lion.
That was sad. That was sadder than the start thing.
As for the points that I brought up, it is a fact that he said that his Sifu died. He cannot back that up. He has not backed it up, and that's what I'm challenging. Let's see. He said that he was in a car crash, and then very soon thereafter appeared in a blog TV naked, and I have video of that, and he had not a bruise on his body. Let's see. There are other people in this call who can testify to the fact that Zelda was chatting on the computer saying that he was touching her too much when he visited. Let's see.
I can say that I spoke to her with a couple of people, and she reiterated that while he was there.
There you go.
I can back up my shit. Every fucking one of the things that I brought up. And there's a lot of shit that I can't fucking back up that I didn't say. You know? I only came with the fucking facts.
Check the Skype chat.
Let's take a look at the Skype chat. Let's see what we got.
I just found the whole I'm going to get late being funny in light of with Phantom Lion randomly sitting one there.
It's fuck yeah.
Well, I don't have no problem getting late. Ain't there, baby now? He's got to go out.
That's correct. The Phantom Lion has been saying a lot that he hasn't had sex in 4 years. He said that to me personally, but apparently he sent it to iCallance in a fucking PM.
I have no idea why.
Yeah, well, that's because I had somebody else tell me that she did have sex with him, and he doesn't want it out that he had sex with that particular person.
Apparently,
for good reason.
Yeah.
Well, personally...
Go ahead and say why.
Shallow, but I don't really give a fuck who's...
Oh, no, Brett. Who. Brett, you want to hear this one.
I should say why.
Brett, listen.
What's up?
Go ahead. No. Go ahead, Christian.
I'm listening.
You shouldn't say why. I'm thinking about it.
You're thinking about it, aren't you?
And I'm like, should I say that out loud? Okay, I'm gonna do it. Fuck it. I don't fuck it. So there is question to the mental stability of this individual.
Yeah.
A guy who wears a kung fu mask.
No.
It's not a kung fu mask.
It's a lion mask.
And we're not talking about the stability of him.
You don't buy your own Phantom Lion mask.
We're not talking about the mental stability of Phantom Lion. We're talking about the mental stability of the person that has attested to knowing him in the biblical sense.
Who's that?
Is it Vigil Draft's foot?
She scratched him behind the ears.
Is that monster video?
Qualifier.
Is that that video I saw with the monster?
That might be it, I guess.
Does this video and does this individual own a snow shovel?
Are they smoking a lot?
Just spit it out. Spill it out.
Yeah.
I don't know. See, that's the thing. I couldn't even tell you who it is or the channel. I just know I saw it.
It's nice breaking. It's been nice talking with everyone else. I'm getting tired. I gotta get up and go to work in the morning.
All right. Yep. See you later. Bye. Keep it real.
Peace out, my nigga.
All right. And the one thing I want to say about everything he said right there is if you're going to be my friend, you should expect that I'm going to fucking be even more critical of you. I like to keep what's around me a little bit more straight than the shit that's not around me. And if you're going to be my friend and be all surprised when I fucking say, hey, you just did something wrong, you know, crying and saying, I thought you were my friend, is not going to fucking work with me. You know? If you did something fucking wrong as what he fucking did, you gotta expect me to fucking call it out. It's called cleaning house. You know?
You know what it's called? It's called actually being a friend. Because a real friend doesn't just put up with the stuff that you're doing. Right. Stupid. One second. You know?
That's right.
You know, someone that cares enough to call you on your shit, I mean, that's a friend.
Thank you very much.
I agree. Friend cares about you and just lets you know if you're going down a dark path. Mm-hmm.
Lisa, are you eating potato chips?
No. See you later there, Happy.
Lisa, what kind of potato chips are you eating?
I wanted to see Happy at least rant about people.
Well, we got one, at least one unexpected rant that happened in this hate club call. Please, somebody else take the next one.
Okay, but seriously, we have to get this shit straight, because this was the most limp dick shit I've ever been in.
What?
What the fuck, man?
You know what? I'm going to blame it on Brett. Brett was like, let's do this, and I was like, rushing to try to get here. I fucking put the blame on Brett, motherfucker Brett.
Well, goddamn, I didn't think it was that difficult to get some haters and fuckers off of YouTube. Yeah.
You're the one who's like, I can bring some haters. I got haters. Where's your fucking haters?
Did you put Brett Keane the asshole in your title?
No, I put Brett Keane's fucking link to his fucking blog TV in the fucking...
Why did fucking destroy Brett Keane? Want the ultimate destruction? Come here on the title.
Pretty much. Because
you can't just put fucking blog TV, here we go.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Now, I guarantee, watch this. Inventor Gorilla, if he goes and posts a video right now, he posts one for 5 seconds saying, Brett Keane asshole is in blog TV right now. Go get him. I guarantee we'll get some love then.
You know what? As a continuation of the drama we just saw, Phantom Lion just says, I'm in. To Christian, I'm reading this off his fucking post. To Christian, I'm in. Thanks for proving to me that I can no longer trust you. And to be honest, I didn't learn the hard way. So when he says I'm in, I imagine that means he's lurking in the blog TV. But see, when we fucking say this shit out in public, you know, we're trying to be beyond reproach here. We're being fucking open. We're not the ones that have something to fucking hide.
There we go. Let's see what else we got here.
I don't know why he doesn't trust me. You know, I didn't. You know.
Because you suck.
I agree.
No, but you know, he was just whining at me the other day, you know, about some shit about trust, you know, and I tried to like weave this fucking master plan of wake the fuck up by saying, you know, trust is one of these things that, you know, it's hard for you to, you know, trust other people if you really don't feel that the people trust you. And only you can, you know, make people or let people trust you, you know, by being honest with them. And it's obvious you've got some honesty issues, you know. And just trying to tell him he needs to stop creating, you know, his life and just live it. And... so I thought it would be good to invite him in here and let him rant a little bit. I had no idea Mike's gonna fucking bring the hammer. I mean, I you know, Mike and I, we've talked about these issues before, and you know, I'm glad that you said that stuff in public, in front of him.
Mm-hmm.
It's good because, you know, like we saw with the whole Ash thing, people creating personas and creating themselves on the internet isn't fucking healthy. Call people out on their shit before they fuck up even more.
You end up with the situation we have here is kind of like we invited somebody who's not really, I guess he doesn't really like confrontation. Is
no.
That the problem? I mean, that's kind of the problem with Ash too, right? He didn't really like face-to-face
confrontation. Right, so he would create something to use as a buffer.
Mm-hmm.
And it got out of control because nobody called him on it. And you know, even in the inner circle, we all talked about Adela and the weirdness, but nobody wanted to touch it because we didn't want to make it worse. We didn't know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't want to get called out, like, you know, and bashed by, you know, how ridiculous is this to accuse somebody of making someone up? Nobody wanted to go there. And look at what happened.
And I'll tell you a big reason why a lot of people didn't, you know, just come out and say the emperor has no clothes in that situation is because they were afraid that they would be on the outside of the circle and no longer popular. And I'm not making that fucking mistake again, be it fucking the Phantom Lion, Ash, I just got blocked by Felita the Geek. She just said she took a second look at the chat that was in this call and decided to block me. That's okay. You know, be it Zelda, who is very popular, you know, I got beef with her for something, and I'm not worried about being unpopular for, you know, bringing it out in the open. I'm not worried about Felita the Geek taking half my fucking old friends that I've had for the last fucking 2 months. You know, if there's been some fucking lies been going on, I want them out in the fucking open because it makes life so much fucking easier.
Well, folks, I have an important announcement real quick. The wife's going to be taking over for a little bit. I got to go take a drop of brown baby Jesus off the pool, all right? Be right back.
Hey, hey, hey.
What? What's up?
Hey.
Hmm.
Knock that shit off, asshole. Hey.
What? In Sweden, what he's doing is making a poop sausage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm going to go make a cupcake. I'm going to have a religious experience. What's wrong?
That's fine.
Alright,
you go enjoy yourself.
Okay. Okay, here's the wife.
Because everybody knows that baby Jesus was white.
No, he wasn't.
I wouldn't say it, but.
Fucking hilarious.
You were thinking it there, IG.
Quality entertainment, people.
Alright. I'm looking in the fucking Skype call, or in the blog TV. Is there someone who we're missing right now? Is there someone?
Michael, you said before that Riff was on, right?
I added him to the call. He just hasn't responded. He's do not disturb, so maybe he didn't even fucking see it.
Shit. Do you think you can send it to him again? Just because?
To be honest, it looks like the call, the blog TV is thinning out.
Alright.
Yeah, there's
13
people.
We definitely have to get this shit organized. Like, James was right though when he said that people don't really know the purpose of this call. They just think it's like everyone's coming in to have fun and be friends and shit like that.
Well, I have a suggestion. Why doesn't everybody on, like, Thursday, we'll schedule it for, you know, and everybody put something on their own channel that's in here now. Spread the word out.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah.
I still never got my question answered of why someone would drop their own docs into a call if they knew they were being recorded.
He didn't know that he was being recorded.
Still, why would you drop your own docs?
I think he's, you know, being selective with what he was saying. I really do.
Yeah.
Well, you know, if he was, I know the exact timestamp to tell Hannibal Barca and the Skeptical Heretic and say, please refute what he said in this call. Because it was at 1 hour and 30 minutes. So,
because
that'll be easy peasy.
And what kind of docs were dropped?
Where he lives, apparently, his home address, and
would you give your home address?
I'm curious about something though. Why would they drop? Why would they bother to drop his docs? I don't even understand that part.
Well, what I've come to understand from Hannibal Barca is, in the extended version of that call, he says some other things about Native Americans. And that's what they wanted out in public, was what he said about Native Americans.
What's wrong with Native Americans?
Well, he's a race tard.
Yeah,
race realist.
Takes a different view on science and genetics and
career. He's a racist, and we think he's a racist.
What the fuck are these turd burgers talking about?
Phantom Lions, Ed Calls, or whoever else.
Who?
Start making sense of Skype call. Basically, in short, he's an individual who lacks reading composition.
Oh, fuck.
Or composition.
Argues evolution for being a racist.
Yeah.
Yep.
Those douchebags.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Haven't you seen Evogen's entire fucking series? You should go to Evogen Video. He's got an entire series.
Well, after Evo's done with the guy that he's on, he'll probably move to Start Making Sense.
Yeah.
Did you hear what I did?
Evogen's got like 15 videos on one guy alone.
Yeah, and they're excellent, dude. They're just packed with all the information, all the... his videos are like a class.
Yes.
He takes the stuff that people say in the documentation they show up with, and then takes it apart and explains what they made all the mistakes.
With documentation and back and sources and everything, yeah. It's It's great work.
Like, it's one thing if you made a statement and made a mistake with the information you had because you didn't understand it. It's another thing to sit there, Dan, and say, no, no, I'm right, when you've been proven you're wrong, and showing how you're wrong.
Yeah, basically, you know. He's one of those that start making sense, seems to be one of those individuals who thinks, because I'm a mud person, I'm inferior.
Oh boy. Who the hell's all these people in tax?
Those are the Miss Pure Fiction is one of them, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who Annie is though.
I do.
And
that's DM Crispin.
Oh, why isn't she in the call?
Well, she should be, but she isn't.
Oh, she can't hear anything over the whining.
Michael?
Uh-huh.
How am I supposed to fit into the hate club?
No. Well,
hate on somebody about?
Yeah, in case of emergency, what we're going to do is we're going to have one of them attack you, and then I'm going to go to ballistic. Like this new level of fucking nuclear hate. We have to have an Achilles heel. That's what it is.
Actually, that's true. We do. Because Brett's kind of funny. So I can't. I mean, he is. He's kind of funny. He amuses the fuck out of me. So it's kind of hard for me to hate on him when he's right there making really ridiculous comments and shit.
Yeah.
I don't get this.
And James is too mellow. IG is fucking hilarious, but, you know, he's not really, like, aggressive. We need a dick, basically.
And Lisa, I thought that I would be coming to this hate club call and not having anyone hate on me, you know, seriously. And then, poof, we have the Phantom Lion, you know, out of nowhere. You know, I was expecting other people to show up, like... the skeptical heretic who wanted to be fucking invited, and he's not even the fuck online. Rith hasn't fucking answered, you know, and Felita didn't want to join the call. You know, I expected a lot of hate for a lot of other people. I never expected that I would be the biggest fucking, you know, one here to get hated on. So sometimes you don't realize when you have haters. Maybe you have a hater. You know?
Yeah, you get Bogger in here. I got some shit I want to see with.
I'm a little curious about the skeptical.
It's not that I'm never rude or hateful. I am. It's just you don't see it.
No, I see.
Like, I'm not provoked here.
I've had conversations with Christian the skeptical heretic. It would be very interesting. He'd be like, Brad, the trajectory of the problem is. I mean, it's just, he takes too long to talk. Boring.
It's because I've never really thought of Skip as being somebody who's, like, particularly, like, super aggressive when it comes to these types of, like, conversations.
Well, he was very enthusiastic about being invited.
Let me show you something. This guy can be fucking ferocious. Don't underestimate him.
I mean, I'm not saying he's not a dick, but, like, he seems so much more, like, I guess diplomatic, not really like aggressive and in your face.
Let's see.
But I guess that's because in his videos he's like significantly different, kind of like how Rith is less of a dick in his videos.
Is he more of a dick in person?
Like, in comment sections, Rith is completely different. Like, he calls, like, if he's arguing with you, he'll call you a retard and just. Pretty fucking ferocious, really, because he got into a fight with Garnet Coyote, and he kept calling him retarded and making fun of the fact that he couldn't make his own videos. I mean, it was completely different. I fucking loved it, but, you know, he has that side of him that he doesn't really show in his videos.
Here you go, check this shit out right here. It's a Musion. There we go. He does sound kind of like Napalm, doesn't he? Napalm's kind of the same way as what you're talking about, different in videos, different in sound, because he's always in Amendum's room, and he's pretty nice and respectful in there towards me, but on video, the dude, you would think that he wants to scream through the screen and rip my damn head off and shit down my neck. Wow. But he's actually a pretty good guy. Let's see what we got. Oh my goodness, this man has ripped me an elbow. We'll see what we got. Do you see the link, guys?
Being hateful, I have it. I have it saved here because I'm probably going to go to sleep in a few minutes. Drinking with Bob. Here we are. Where am I?
I love drinking with Bob. He is so fucking funny.
Yeah, it is. What's next? What's next? Yeah, Skeptical Heretic, he cracks me up, though. He's got this sense of humor about him. He's like, Brett is the worst of us. He's a drunk. And then he takes a drink of some fucking alcohol while he says that. I'm just like, oh, that's beautiful. Great. He goes, Brett plays video games all fucking day. And then the very next video is, yeah, me and Brett, we were playing some video games. What a bitch. I love it. Let's see what we got. Yeah, somebody said to me today, all you do, Brad, is play that fucking World of Warcraft, and I said, wrong. Now I'm playing Skyrim. Fuck them.
Yeah, if you're going to accuse someone playing video games, at least get the game right.
That is correct.
I think the type of game says a lot of about you, you know?
What do you think about Skyrim?
Me? I'm still in the only, like, level 14 or 15. I haven't really spent much time. I've been busy playing Battlefield 3 on PlayStation Network.
You would play fucking Battlefield.
Blowing shit up.
Fucking, that wanted to say something, but I couldn't remember it. Fuck, I suck.
I'm not really one of those third-person shooters. I used to love Unreal Tournament and the old GoldenEye. That was kind of cool.
Yep.
A lot of these fucking games nowadays, Halo is just too much. I like fucking head kill, you know?
That's why I like Battlefield 3. Well, Battlefield 3 is, it's a little bit, it's like, slow pace, so it's not cartoon paced, you know? And you can fly the vehicles, you can fly the helicopters and the jets and drive the tanks and armored vehicles and...
It's much more realistic, I'm guessing?
But it's way more, it's like really realistic. So, it's a lot of fun.
It's like IG's back in the military. Killing terrorists.
Surviving on cacti in the deserts of Africa.
Oh, you.
Deserts of Baghdad.
That's not in Africa. That's in the Middle East.
You used to like the old Mortal Kombat and Killer Instinct. You guys ever play that one?
I play Killer Instinct and Mortal Kombat, actually.
Combos are in that shit. Wow, wow, wow.
Yeah.
Square,
square, triangle.
Yeah.
A lot of people, though, play, like, FPSs and shooters and shit, so...
Yeah.
I don't really have much that I can tell anyone that I can really talk to about my taste in regards to video games and shit.
I want to hear it. Talk about it. All the fucking haters left. Nothing fun to do there.
Alright, that's true. I like,
Wait. If we're gonna go to fucking talking about video games, we need to fucking end the hate club right the fuck now.
Yeah.
We need to fucking pull the plug, Brett.
Well, you're the one that's got the video posted. Nobody wants to kill each other, unfortunately.
Because nobody's answering. If fucking Riff or somebody would answer the goddamn phone, we could fucking tear each other apart or something.
Are you talking about Cardinal Virtues?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, shit, dude. I already got him fucking recorded on my site saying he's always going to be nice to me, so that, I don't think that'll work.
All
right.
Who's he gonna go after?
That's true, because he can't. The only person in here that I think he has an issue with is James, because of this that shit that he was in a while ago with a few other people. over the Occupy Wall Street shit. I don't know if he still hates the dude. I imagine he does because I remember him saying something offhandedly about James in the video, but that's about it.
All right. Well, if you want to remove the fucking video and let people know it's video game talk time, that's fine with me. I don't know if Blog TV has the same effect as Stickam, but I know that when I've been in Stickam and I get in a conversation with people about video games, people start leaving in fucking droves, but I don't give a shit. I don't like video games.
Alright, well, I've got a screen cap of everyone who was left when the dust cleared. And hopefully we all come back to get hated on next time.
I'm probably going to go to sleep anyway.
I'll think of some videos to piss some people off.
Okay.
I got a couple ideas.
What ideas you got?